Thank you. so hard. Put this pussy right in your face. Swipe your nose like a credit card. Hop on top, I wanna ride. I do a kink, what else is that? Spit in my mouth, look in my eyes. Pussy is wet, come take a dive. Sign me up like I'm surprised. That's what play, I wear disguise. I want you to park that Big Mac truck right in the state of the ride. Make it cream, make me scream. I don't put it, make a scene. I don't cook, I don't clean, but let me tell you, I got this dream.
Surely you should be a mod. Anyway. Good evening. Oh, God, my ear is all over the place. It's probably because I did some unusual. I washed it. Yeah. I had to make myself somewhat presentable for the... Hey, Mike. Ugh. You're here to lurk. Well, then you don't have to tell me, do you? You just lurk. I mean, you don't... You haven't really got this, have you? It's like when someone says, I'm quietly confident. Well, evidently not. You know. You're here for the massacre. Yes, the title of the video, the Adrian G part, that will start. I'll start that probably... I'll see if the room gets up a bit. Get it up to like... Maybe just before 10 or 10 o'clock-ish. But all of that, you might have noticed the seamlessness in the intro. There was no gaps between the song because I was mixing. I was mixing on me old, you know, on that, this motherfucker here. Yes, because it wasn't enough that I've already got, you know, a DJ controller with two turntables and an actual turntable. Now I've got a fucking a blog TV that's, oh, mate, you don't even know. Oh, mate. You missed a couple. It was a couple of months ago now, but we did the. Do you know? It was recently the 10. I think you saw my post on Facebook. It was 10 years since the Straight Dope blog, Brett Keane blog TV, which, as those of you who you know who have seen it, you know, will know, and as those of you who were there will testify, greatest online live debate ever. You know. Well, you can't have too many musical instruments technically, but I mean you can have too many musical instruments that you don't know how to play. You know. But I've just become obsessed with like all the buttons and all the fucking bit and the dials and the fucking yeah. I think I watch that once. I probably like regularly, like probably like 5 times a year. I probably dip back to the. With Block TV, there was a bit of a. It was a certain sort of like. Anything goes feel with it, because like they didn't give a shit about enforcing the terms of service. I know this because I did a show once where I deliberately broke every single terms of service every single rule they had listed of things you couldn't do. And there was a time I was doing, I did DevShell's HIV charity show, and I said that if we get $1,000 in my hour, I will get my balls out. And I got a private message from the Blog TV moderator saying, please do not show your balls on Blog TV. I don't think it was the internet per se. I think places like that can still exist. It's just that, you know, it was before. It was before a time when people took the internet seriously, and they knew what it was really. Well, that's back when you could get any video. Any video got monetized. They didn't. YouTube never even checked it. You know, there was no copyright ID. You know, you could make a video response and actually like, you know. Mention the say the name of the person who you were responding to and link their video without getting flagged for harassment, you know. But I'll give YouTube credit for one thing. It's like that we spent all those years moaning about the flagging system, about how bad it was, and how, you know, and how open to abuse and stuff like that it was. And then YouTube went and like fixed it, and they somehow made it worse, which I don't think is even. Well, no, To be fair, it probably wasn't the Nazi attitude, it probably wasn't flagged for hate speech. It was probably auto-flagged, because I've had, I uploaded several videos that were, that you know, in back in 2019, I uploaded like three or four videos that all got auto-flagged that were debunking Holocaust deniers. And they all got all of it because they had the words Holocaust and Nazi. I can't upload. I haven't been able to re-upload any of the racist website Safari Hunts, apart from one. I think only the first one. You know, but I tried uploading all the others, and I uploaded all the others, and I put them on private. And two of them got flagged, auto-flagged. And so it must have been the algorithm, because there was no one would have been able to see the video. And I took the other two down before they could do it again. But yeah, it's but they don't do it with everyone. I mean, it's very generally, if the videos are older, like. The algorithm doesn't get round to it, doing his thing. He's not really doing his thing anymore. I mean, he's calmed down a lot now. He does one video a week. He's cut down from he's no longer doing his seven videos a day stuff, you know, which is... Now, isn't the phrase, is the phrase not meant to be full of pith and vinegar? I thought it was, but people just changed it to piss because pith didn't make any sense, because no one knows what pith is. It's filled with pith and not fueled by pith and vinegar. Did they do a social media boycott? You know what? I didn't notice. And you know what? As every time they try and organise one of these, I constantly have to point out to them, like, it's fucking pointless. You know, by all means, do it. I will not... You know, if that's what you want to do, by all means, but it will make a sod all difference. You know? Do you know what? There's some... for me, here's the thing about a lot of these videos that people make about sort of like... there are certain channels that I feel do it in a really cynical way. Like, there's one channel called Gamer from Mars, and all of his videos are just him talking about other YouTubers who used to be successful and all over the place, and now they're not so much. And I wouldn't mind, but almost all of them have still get more views than he does. And I just feel that's like a little... When you base an entire channel on that, like, Down the Rabbit Hole does it properly. Like, he does it in a way that I feel is respectful and telling an actual story. And there's other people who do it right. But there's some that are just, you know... Like, it's just about sort of pointing out, hey, these people used to be popular and now they're not. It's like, yeah, that's what happens, mate. That's... I don't remember the atheist going on strike. I do remember on one specific occasion, Fake Sagan went on strike on his own. But that was... And to be fair, this was 2009. He probably had more of an impact on his own. Well, I mean, the thing is, because there are so many channels that have, like, huge subscriber bases, people have a weird definition of, like some of the channels that are called dead channels. Like, they still get fucking, like, they still get, like, 200,000 fucking views. I'm like, I wouldn't mind fucking having a dead channel with 200 pissing thousand views a video. I mean, strictly speaking, no one gets anywhere. No one uploads videos that, you know, there's very few people who get, you know, views that are, you know, comparable to their actual fucking, what's Fake Sagan? Fake Sagan's still on YouTube. He still makes videos. He's completely different. He's, you, I think he's nothing's changed since he was a Christian, and he's a bit more right wing, bit of a conspiracy theorist. Yeah, but I mean, I never really watched Spoonie. I wasn't around. He was sort of like, he happened sort of before my time and that. But I mean, but the thing is, he was a guy who had potential, but he blew it, you know, because he kept shooting himself in the foot. I mean, he was good when he wanted to be. But again, but here's another thing. The thing is, I think you've got to remember is back in 2006, 2007, 2008, it's like, you know, I always bring this point up when people are talking about comparing music nowadays to music from the 60s and the 50s. And I'm like, back then, they had nothing to compare it to because it was new. There was nothing. No one goes back to the 40s or the 30s. You know, and when you've got like, and back then in 2007, 2008, 2009, like there was so much stuff that you could do and you could be the first person doing it. I mean, let's not forget the most prominent and the guy who was pretty much the top atheist, the first big sort of name atheist on YouTube. Who was it? Yeah. So, he has some of an audience, yeah, but I mean, he'll never get it. But I mean, you know, and I'm not gonna. I'm not gonna bust on him for it because I've been guilty of, you know, many of the things that he's been guilty of. I mean, I think I've sort of. But he seems to have never really got over it. You know, I mean, things have been. I mean, I've told my story before, like back in when I started back in like late 2008, just a few months after I'd started, and I was getting my channel was sort of taking off, and on Skype I started getting these messages from a guy who I didn't know, whose name I didn't recognise, but trying to start a conversation about sort of like something I've talked about in my last video, and I had no idea who the guy was, and he was contacting me once a month for like into 2009, and I never replied because, like I said, I didn't know who the fuck he was. And a couple of years later, I was watching the Nostalgia Critic, and I realised his name was Doug Walker, and I'm like, where have I heard that name before? Oh, that was the motherfucker who was contacting me. Like, I was getting messages from the Nostalgia Critic was messaging me in 2008 for 6 months, and I was just blanking him. I didn't respond to it because I had no idea who the fuck he was. You'd think he might have introduced himself, and maybe I would have fucking, you know. Although, seeing as how that all turned out, maybe that was, you know, maybe that was for the best. I had the opportunity back in, I think it was 2000, I think it was 2010, and I had the opportunity to possibly, you know, have my channel linked up with the Young Turks, and I turned that down. What do I mean? What happened to Nostalgia Creek? Dude, don't you remember, like, a couple of years ago, like, there was just, like, the whole Channel Awesome thing was just fucking exposed by loads of people who were in it for like the really shitty, like abusive, like harassment and fucking, you know, it was like got caught up in the whole sort of like the whole Me Too thing when people were coming forward and stuff, and it was, you know, I mean, it's still around, but I mean, it's like, it's, you know, there's, you know, it's a lot of people, you know, soured on it and fucking. maybe he is. Look, I don't know the guy. I'm not gonna. I can't judge. I wasn't there. I don't know. You know, it's But when it, but enough people, it's like the old thing, when you have enough people come forward and saying the same thing, I would love to sell out. Oh God, I would fucking, if the NWO or the Illuminati were real and they phoned me up, if Soros was anywhere near the monster he's made out to be, and he called me up saying, can you shill for me? I'd be like, damn right. That's no excuse. Saying something's a cruel bastard of a business, that's not true. Things don't have to be. That's no excuse for, there are certain things there are certain aspects of it that, everyone has to deal with that are straightforward, but you can't really sit there and say, it doesn't happen to everyone, does it? I mean, he properly put. I mean, the nostalgia critic, the most heinous thing he'd done. The only thing he'd done recently that got any sort of recognition was that fucking awful video review of The Wall by Pink Floyd. And I say that as a guy who hates Pink Floyd, and a guy who loves Slipknot and Corey Taylor and his son are in that video, and I have no idea how the fuck he got them in it, There was a channel, I forget the name of the woman who runs it, but I mean, she's got literally like 10,000 subs, but her first video I saw, she was interviewing Anthony Cumier from Opie and Anthony. I'm like, fucking hell, I might have a shot. That would be fucking hilarious. Old. Yeah. Now he's gone like full, like, rape. Now he's like full racist. I'll be sat there, stuck between wanting to just sit there and do Vince McMahon impression and Jesse Ventura impressions. No, Corey Taylor could not have saved that review. I mean, Corey Taylor was just, the fact his son was in it suggests to me that his son is probably a fan of the videos, and you get these big famous people. That's why one of the best sort of ownage response videos was iDubbbz. When iDubbbz did his content cop on Rice Gum, and Rice Gum responded by doing a diss track that used a Post Malone, that used the instrumental track from a Post Malone song, and then iDubbbz responded by actually having Post Malone in his fucking video. I mean, that is just, that was just, mwah. Yeah, it would be great streaming games, but the thing about streaming games is it's easy to, there's so many people doing it, and it's like, in order to stand out, you've got to have a really sort of dynamic personality. Your content is good. I know. Thank you. You're right. It's not good, mate. It's the shit. It's the best thing going today. As long as I'm on this website, nobody else can claim to be anything other than a step below me. I think he could have just, Napalm could have just, well, I mean, the thing about Napalm is that was back when, before, like, you know, I mean, I remember Michael from, like, Michael from Rooster Teeth had that Rage Quit show, and I'm like, Napalm could have done something like that if he'd just edited his videos down, you know. I remember just driving Napalm insane. Every time he uploaded a new video, I would share it out and say, go post comments saying Tower Toppler. And I forced him to do all six, like, forced him to make like 8 videos doing it. There was, some of his videos, I think he had, he did some movie reviews that were edited. It had, did I vote in the local elections? Dude, I didn't even realise there was a fucking election until yesterday. I'm in one of the safest Tory seats in the country. It wouldn't make any fucking difference. Count Binface is not running, so I'm not, you know. I mean, the mayoral election of London is pretty much has been pretty much a given that it's going to be Sadiq Khan was going to win for ages. He was miles ahead of everyone, which is good, you know, because. The Tories have tried blaming him for every sort of everything that's happened as a result of fucking decisions they've made, you know. And they make decisions that affect London, and then he gets the blame for it. And it's like, what the fuck's he supposed to friggin' do? Yeah. I'm more interested in the back end of the mayoral election, with Binface and Lawrence Fox, and that YouTube guy, and Brian Rose. And fucking Piers Corbyn. I just want. I hope they all get thrashed. The North East. Well, it was bound to happen sooner or later. Well, I mean, I sort of came across Brian Rose about a month or so ago through, like, it was sort of suggested to me on Scribd, his podcast. I'd never heard of it before. And then, but I watch, there's a channel I watch called Coffeezilla, which is really good. You should all subscribe to him. And he started, he's got, like, 12 videos on Brian Rose, because Brian Rose has this habit of censoring any video in which people mention him, and that he recently went on this YouTube channel called Politics Relaxed, which is there's like 3 different people who are on it, and they're all kids. They're all kit for kids who are like 15 years old, and they fucking crucified him, and he fucking bailed out of the fucking interview like 20 minutes early. And I just love what I love it when fucking I love watching. It always happens. Like people just, you know, people always underestimate. Like, you know, they underestimate kids. They think kids are going to give him an easy ride. He's not a big David Icke fan. He was a big David Icke fan because David Icke was going to get him views. You know, he's a big fan of saying he's one of these cunts who'll say anything that, you know. Like he was going to be setting up his own like fucking video site where it was, you know, that was going to be like free, where it was going to be, there's going to be no censorship, which is like he never did. And he raised like fucking 2.5 million for that. And it never happened. And then he started fucking taking donations for his fucking mayoral campaign, which he's going to. He even on one, you know, at one point he even like made a video claiming that, you know, he went and put a bet on himself. Like a huge amount of money on himself, and the bookmakers like immediately like decreased his odds because of it, like they do when someone puts a huge bet on it, and then he goes around saying, "Oh, I'm second in the race according to power bookmakers." I'm like, "Yes, because you just someone because some mysterious donor put $500,000 fucking quid." On you, so they shorten the odds, and then you make your video. But you're in, you know. But then Paddy Power themselves, Ladbrokes, I think it was, they wrote an article saying that, you know, Brian Rose has had no effect on polling. Yeah, I've been over that one. It's not really a conspiracy. I mean, there are probably some people who believe it, but I mean, it was really sort of started. The reason people stick with it is because it actually offends Alex Jones. He actually gets pissed off about that conspiracy theory, because if Bill Hicks was alive, because Alex Jones, believe it or not, is only like 4 or 5 years older than me. But if Bill Hicks were alive today, he'd be like in his 60s. So Alex Jones gets very sensitive about that because it's like people are saying you look like someone who could be a fucking old age pensioner. Oh, in Holland we have 17 parliaments. Yes, we have the gay weed smoking party. The weed smoking gay party. We have all, this is Hans. He is my partner and also my lover. Anyway, so, Adrian G. Now, since I uploaded that video last week on Mr. Grushka, I did a little bit snooping around, see what I could find. At one point, thought I had come across a fucking proper massive scoop. Yes, sorry, AG. You know, as he is to me, or just as he is to me, because me and him, we're part of a brotherhood now. We're part of the Fellowship of the Ring piece. And now, unfortunately, what I'm about to read to you, it turned out to be not what I thought, right? But it was a Facebook post, and all of this stuff was legit. This evening, Adrian G, the owner of Dub Sector, which is a sort of like a record label or sort of like, you know, sort of collective, whatever, to do with dubstep, decided to come out of the pop-up that Jonah Holter and I put on. It was a great day. Everyone was having a good time until this fucking piece of shit decided to follow a girl who was so inebriated she could barely talk up a dark hill. Luckily, Taylor Driffin's sixth female sense kicked in just in time. Because she and Hayley Irene had a feeling the girl was in trouble. Well, shortly after we discussed this, we all walked up the hill to find this fucking rapist on top of her, and we ran up and to pull him off, and he got up and ran away. I then found out, did a little bit of extra digging, because it seemed, I couldn't find anything about him being connected to any dubstep organisation. It was a completely different Adrian G. He still spelt it Adrian G, like two E's, but his name was Adrian Goff. And I was like, I mean, isn't that the worst fucking news you've ever fucking... Have you ever been so disappointed to find out someone isn't a rapist? And can you call yourself Lewis B? I guess, suppose so. If you want. I mean, no one call... Does anyone call you Lewis? I mean, your name is virtually B. It's Beach. It's almost there. Yeah. So that was a different... Now, I share that, though, because it's important to sort of, like, make the point of, like, you know, just because you want something to be true, you shouldn't. However, I will say this. One of the first things I found is one of the first things I found was this screenshot, which is Adrian G on Chatterbait. Brought streaming on Chatterbait under the name Patrick Sweeps. You know, so there you go. That's all I've got. I didn't go and fucking do any more deep research beyond that. I didn't want to know, you know. But, and this is where I've got to, this is where I'm going to bring in the background. Now, what I did do is the video that I watched of him, the video I watched was him promoting his dating his pickup course, which is called the T8 system. And so I figured, well, let's have a look, you know, let's see, let's have a look, see, to see, like, you know, so I Googled Adrian G T8 review, and this is seriously what I found, right? These are the things I came across. Now let me just this was the first one I came across. Let's put it, it's display. There we go. Right. Now this was the first one I came across. Now before we get into this, let me just pop the chat out so I can see. Now, this is a website, which, as you can see, if I bring it over here, this is a website called regionvavid.org. It's run by a guy called Eugene Walters. Now, this is a website that reviews stuff, as you can see from the things up here, fat loss, health, fitness, dating, relationships. But I was slightly suspicious of it because if you go to the front page, I'm suspicious as to the legitimacy of his reviews. Now, what I'm going to go through. All of these reviews were posted on the same day, right? Oh yeah. But by the way, my nickname for Adrian G, because of his rapey demeanour and the fact he's Australian, is Kangaroo Shv. So, the half day diet plan review, the TC1 200 tactical flashlight review, the acid alkaline balanced diet review. the Super Memory Formula Program Review, the Auto Tweets Bot Review, the Algorithm Diet Review, the High IQ Pro Software Review, Make Him Worship You Review, the Psoriasis Free for Life Review, Old School New Body Review, Neuroactive Review, DIY Bike Repair Videos Review, Harmonium Sleep Support Review, Messages of an Obsession Review, Takeover Survival Plan Review, Shapeshifter Yoga Review, Piano by Chords Review, The Metabolic Reboot Review, Digital Marketing Career Blueprint Review, Neuro Vector Review, Attract and Keep Her Review, Adonis Golden Ratio Review, Modern Day Magnetic Attraction Review, Toned in 10 Review, Conversation Chemistry Review, Ancient Secrets of Kings Review, Rocket Italian Review, Isometrics Mass Review, How to Bug in Forever Review, Yeast Infection No More Review, why or how he could review that, I don't know. And that's it. Those are the last ones. All of those things I've just read out were all posted on the same day. There is no way on fucking earth he could possibly have reviewed all of those in a fucking 6 month period, let alone a week. And just to show that it's not like he just posts a load at once. The next one's below, like Lepto Connect review, February 13th, February 14th. Oh, Pheromone Advantage review, 14th. You know, Supreme Self Confidence, February 13th. Hike, you know. So basically, all of this stuff, and he basically, now, so what this says to me is that this is a guy who just posts reviews to promote stuff, presumably for a fee. He is a prolific writer. He's not a very good one, though, as we're about to see. I'm going to read to you now his review of the T8 system. Let's see whether or not we believe that this is a legitimate review. These are pictures, by the way. That is not Adrian G. You can tell that because there's a woman standing very close to him. So Adrian G. Now this is. Pay attention to this bit. It's very important. January 31st, 2001. January 31st. Okay, so remember that. User rating 5 out of 5. One reviewer. We'll get to that. The TH system. Author, creator, Adrian G. Do you have dating issues? Do you want to improve your way, tactics and skills? I don't know what way means. This fantastic guy by the name of Adrian G. Now, right away, there's only two reasons you would refer to Adrian G. as a fantastic guy. One, you've never fucking met or encountered or watched 2 seconds of the bastard. Or two, you're being paid. That is it. Adrian G. brings to you this excellent program to help you learn all the skills and techniques that will leave ladies falling for your seductions and your vibes. Personally, some of us find it hard to approach women, especially when we have a crush on them. Aww. At other times, we get to find our way to them, but once we are there, you run out of words. Well, is it you or we? You're a fucking blogger for a living. You literally write blogs for a living. That isn't a curse or something. It is just you have to work on your social and man skills. Man skills. Well, this T8 system review is to tell you everything I loved about it. At first, I felt a little embarrassed to read these. However, everything my parents told me just didn't apply to... What did your parents honestly teach you about pulling birds? That is not a conversation I or anyone else... Dad, I really want to smash this girl at work. How do I go about that? Well, son, have you learnt game? No, no, father. No. I mean, some things were great, but I didn't know how to apply that in life. How? What was that? Well, that completely with this system. It's not even a sentence. I don't even know what he's trying. I don't even know what words. He's missed a load of words out there. First, I became aware of what the new dating world looked like. I mean, the new dating world. The whole new world. Then I understood precisely what they wanted and how to give it to them. Up the fucking arse, man. Finally, my dating life improved, and now I've been in a committed relationship for years. Okay, how are you reviewing this now, years afterwards? So what, you did this years ago and didn't bother writing about it until now? I mean, he's saying he's been in a relationship for years and he attributes it to this fucking review, to this course. So he must surely have done this years ago and has only just started. There's another photo there. Again, that's not Adrian, unless he's super glued his hand to her. Okay. Table of contents. Right. You'll notice that at the bottom of the page, that visit the TH system site. That's there always. Almost like they're advertising it. What is the TH system? In essence, the TH system is a step-by-step dating guide and a seduction program. It helps whoever opts for it to understand the methods, techniques, and tricks which will help them to get chicks and get laid at last. I don't want to get laid last, I want to get laid first. No. This guide was created, listen to this sentence. This guide was created by this man known as Adrian Grushka, mostly known as Adrian G. Who writes like that? Who described, but created by this man? Well, obviously, it was this man known as by Adrian Grushka. He could have just written, mostly known. He's not mostly known as anything. He's barely known as Adrian. He equips you with all that it takes, from the looks, vibe, social skills, and much more to get any woman you want. Right, I want B. Arthur. I want Martina Navratilova and B. Arthur in a three-way in a lift. Right. Will that help me get this? No. I want Jackie Onassis. Right. Now this again, I don't know what he's trying to... Now, you don't have to be a diehard whenever you want to bring the opposite sex your way. Now, a diehard is someone who stands by... It's like a fanboy. Someone who stands by something or stands against something, even in the face of strong opposition against or for that thing, which makes no sense in this sentence. My assumption is that he's... By diehard... He's referring to the movie Die Hard, as in John McClane. But Die Hard is not a single word in that. It's Die Hard. It's two separate words. All you need is a guide that will help you be attractive, and now you get to pick the one you want. Is that one mine? Yeah. Look at those. Look at them over there, sat there, screaming for it. They want to have it off with someone. Personally, the system... Listen to this. Does this sound believable? Personally, the system helped many of my friends. And that's how I knew about it. Does anyone here know, has anyone here ever known one person who they call a friend who's ever used one of these pickup artists or dating fucking programs? Let alone many friends. Unless they're all in the same Dungeons and Dragons group, I imagine. They all play Warhammer. Yeah. What have you got for me? Sarah Ferguson. Now, I've inputted your data.
Ooh.
Right, let's have a look at yours, Mr. Richard. Well, here in the office. It's a bit thorough, isn't it? And it even helped me to truly amazing results with attracting the opposite sex. I don't know who this bird is. Yeah. Grab your copy here. Now, another link. Yeah. Basically, the TH... Now, this is... Now, as you may remember from the video I responded to, Adrian has a habit of frequently using, like, figurative or metaphorical language or similes that sound incredibly creepy. Get this. Basically, the TH system is a comprehensive video system crafted by someone who has not only experienced but also studied and perfected the skills. I don't care whether he studied. I'm assuming experience would be enough. In what, I don't know. Right? He comes to help you go through the phases of... Here are the phases. Number one, bagging a woman. Do you remember him talking about women getting bagged up like groceries? Hanging in the back of my crib like trophies. You know, I'm like a dope freeze. Hope, but you know, sorry. But apparently that's number one, attracting her. Apparently you bag her up before you attract her. I like the way you work it. No diggity. I got to bag it up, babe. I like the way... So, attracting her. Make her fall for you on the first date. Make her. Right. Letting her crave for your calls. Seducing her. Sleeping with her. Why doesn't anyone have any sex with me? Having a long relationship. Here you will get a step-by-step blueprint to master the art of seduction and pickup, presumably pickup and then seduction, thus changing your entire life. You will not only improve your dating life, but your whole life as well. The way of life, among others. The way of life. Adrian G, for he is the way, the truth and the light. About the author, Adrian G. Well, to you, mate. To me, he's AG, or... Mr. AG, middle name certified. As I mentioned earlier, the author of this fantastic dating guide is Adrian G. His name is... This is a bit... His name is Adriana Grushka. So he's not only now apparently had a sex change... He's also changed his last name and added an I to it. I bet Adrian was well happy about that. But he prefers the G instead. He prefers the G. Yeah, I bet he prefers the G. He's one big fucking repressed G. Now, Adrian is a dating coach, entertainer, and entrepreneur. What a great way of just saying full of shit. Now, I think that is a picture of Adrian. And may I say, Adrian, you should stick with that lighting. That is the best you've ever looked, right? This is obviously... I like how the woman there is not even looking at him. She's looking right over there. Listen to this sentence. He has a career on online entertainer and content creator... to his current role as a writer who has authored several dating guides, none of which are more than 100 pages long, by the way. And one of them is literally called Female Mind Control System. I shit you not. And he claims he can teach you, and it's $60 and he claims he can teach you to control the thoughts of women. Well, if that's the case, why do you have to keep hiring actors, you fucking bony little fucking homo? Now, in his bio, I found that G, that's A-G to the rest of it, G has always been taking it seriously and focusing intently on the well-being and success of his clients. So he's been doing his job. Thank you. In essence, he has spent many years researching attraction, seduction, and pickup artistry. Also, he has studied the path of the best seducers, read a lot of dating courses, and pickup artist systems. Listen to this. With his experience, he developed his methods and strategies that worked perfectly well. Later on, Adrian G opted for a 5-year study on attraction and seduction after 2 years of fine-tuning. It took him 7 years. It took him seven fucking years to come up with this system. You should be able to get laid by accident in 7 years. He uses all of the understanding and experience to provide something unlike anything else that reviews will lead you to out there. What does that... That's not... Is that even coherent? What will you get with this program? This again is important. A 5-week vocal tonality master. Now you saw that video I made and you could... Does anyone honestly think that Adrian G should be teaching people how to speak? It's a formula that will help you turn her on through voice. He couldn't turn on a fucking shortwave radio with his voice. Jesus Christ, you could fucking hear... You know, he might make a woman's uterus prolapse, but apart from that, this guide will help you avoid her defences, resistance, and psychologically access her sensitive cravings. Now that... There, avoid her... defenses and resistance. Again, this is a photo. Again, it's a very sexy half-naked young woman in denim hot pants with a guy who's definitely not Adrian G. Look, there's muscle definition. He doesn't look like a fucking wand. Fucking wand with teeth. Right. The TH community. Connect with other fucking... sad sacks of shit in your city or worldwide. Gain in alibis, as they're known. Gain insights from other people around you. The Secret Advanced Training ebooks, Kill the Friend Zone, Master the Tinder Game. It's not difficult, mate. Learn the basics of not being cheated. The No Fear Motivational MP3s. Adrian calls it additional pep. You will never force yourself to go ladies that you don't desire. Face the crush of your life. So imagine this. You see a girl you like at the bar or somewhere. But before you do, you've got to get your iPod. You've got to get your phone out and play a motivational MP3 read by this fucking row of 127 fucking teeth in a beanpole. Fucking, you know, it's just... This deflated Ted Bundy. The Powerful 60. This is a 60-minute exclusive interview with a chick Adrian picked up. Now, this is important here. Right there. With a chick. Now, I mentioned this in my video. He calls women chicks, but he spells them chic. just like it's written there. Now, which says to me that this shit is copied and pasted either from the website by Eugene or it's fucking, like, Adrian's just sent him what he wants him to post, along with a fucking check. Learn what you need to improve to be named one of the successful ones. What do you mean, one of the successful ones? Is that to enter the Brotherhood? This provides detailed insights from the lady's viewpoint on precisely what you have to do. Why couldn't I just ask her in the fucking first place? You know? Like I said in my video, why don't men figure this out? I could fucking get a lady's viewpoint without... I don't need to fucking pay this arsehole $700 million, whatever it is, and spend 5 weeks learning how to talk like a fucking... like a sexual deviant, right? Where can you buy the TH system? Well, I wonder. Could it be in every fucking link that you've posted in every single fucking page of this? Conclusion. The TH system is straightforward to use and you are not going to experience any problems while handling it. Personally, my friends and I used it together to get girls while going out. Did you really? Boy, that sounds like a fucking riot. What a fucking fun lot you must be. Fucking hell. Jesus Christ. Like a fucking... it's like the Scooby-Doo rapist fucking, you know, but the van's used for something else. For me, I got a girlfriend. They, however, keep getting laid. So this program is suitable for anyone, regardless of their purpose. Yes, if your purpose is to get a girlfriend... or not get one, but get laid. If that's your purpose. Also, the program guarantees the best results. Well, there you go. I mean, that'll do for me, wouldn't it? Because as we know, all products that are scams, you know, clearly state that. Therefore, don't have to worry if you don't have to worry if you have ever used such a book or not. What do you mean used a book? I know how to read, arsehole. Even better, it's appropriate for both beginners and those who just need more powerful techniques. Stronger rope. Finally, it comes with a 60-day full money-back guarantee that states the program is legitimate and G believes it will give you nothing but the best. Get the girl you want and sex or forever. For sex or forever. Oh, those are the two options. So, like, if you get her forever, you're not fucking. This is the best guide to consolidate your alpha status. He talks about it like it's fucking one of those debt companies. Do you find you have too much debt to pay off? Here at Adrian G Industries, we'll consolidate all of your alpha, all of your alpha male fucking issues, and consolidate them into one affordable monthly alpha issue. Click on the button below to get your copy. I fucking wouldn't do it. You couldn't. I wouldn't do it if my fucking arms fell off, mate. Pros and cons. Pros, easy to get and follow. Yeah, it's in the post. The program is written in an easy to understand language that everyone can understand. Yes, English, motherfucker! Maybe you could write one of your blogs in that language. Learn from real scenarios. I don't want that. I don't want real scenarios. I want ones involving elves and pixies and orcs and fucking... goblins and wizards. That's what I want. The TH system is genuine and real. And therefore, it will teach you the appropriate... genuine and real. Win in every part of your relationship. It prepares you not only psychologically, but also physically. How? How could it possibly prepare me physically? It's not supposed to be hard. I think you'll find that's the actual point, mate. The TH system introduces you to the best natural and legitimate ways that you can improve your romantic nature. I don't want the... I want unnatural ways. I want witches round a cauldron going, Eye of Newt, and... I want to go to that fucking cottage in Loch Lomond that fucking Aleister Crowley went to do the Abramelin fucking thing and summon a demon. Try it risk-free. You are protected by a 60-day money-back guarantee. This shows how much the author believes in the programme. Yes, because obviously men who are this insecure, who buy this shit, are going to totally have the confidence, if it hasn't worked after 2 months, to go, sorry, Adrian, I haven't had a fucking sniff, mate. I am that much of a loser that even your amazing, perfect, brilliant system that's guaranteed. If he had faith in it, it wouldn't be a 60-day back guarantee. It would be a 60-minge back guarantee. It would be a 60-pair-of-titties back guarantee. Yeah. That's what it'd be. It'd be a sick. It'd be, you know, yeah, that's what it would. Yeah. Cons. It takes commitment. It does not guarantee you overnight results. And therefore, you are supposed to have patience. This is for 35-year-old virgins. How much more patience do they need? Summary. The TH system is a step-by-step dating guide and a seduction program by Adriana G, who does exist, by the way. Apparently she's a bodybuilder. That builds a strong base on dating basics. It teaches you the techniques and skills on how to handle the lady best, being romantic, and how to build a great relationship. Relationships are difficult for everyone! But it's mainly because they don't know what to do. What, nobody knows what to do. What, everyone doesn't know what to do. Some of them must do by fucking law of averages. Now you'll have everything you need to learn and have the best relationship you've ever had. Well, that shouldn't be too difficult. Now, pay attention, because this is where it gets interesting. Right? There is one comment. It's been given one 5 out of 5 rating from one reviewers. Right? Let's read this. It's posted by John A. Have you ever heard a more bullshit fucking... They might as well have put John Doe. A man, they might as well have put. This is what it says. When I was told about this product by one of my friends, I never believed him. At first, I thought it was some scam products that do not even work. I am so happy that through this system, I have been able to change my life a lot. The truth is that I have been able to get the best tips that have helped me get girls easily and within a short time. Because this is how human beings talk. That sounds like the word something a human has written, isn't it? But, let's go back to the start. What was the date that this fucking blog was written? It was January 2021, wasn't it? Right? Look at the date that it says here. John A. on 2018, the 1st of August. This comment was posted 3 years before this article was even written. Now, remember that. Remember all what you've just seen. Because we can then look at another review I found on this fucking god awful pile of shit. This is from Dating Skills Masters. Look at this. I mean, look at this fucking prick. Look at him. He's like Morrissey, but a slow version. Look at that fucking mouth. Fucking. He looks like he's wearing a fucking stupid suit. He's like, I just want to get a fucking coat hanger and just hang it in. A fucking mouth breather with a quiff. Hi guys, my name is Daniel, and I am crazy when it comes to dating advice and experience. As a guy who used to struggle a lot, I have experienced enough hardships and setbacks. That's why I created this blog. Here I will share my own thoughts. That shouldn't take too fucking long. Research, mate. And give you as much help and advice as I can to help you get that beautiful girl you've had your eyes on so that you can finally start living the dream. And here he is, here, reviewing Adrian Grushka's The TH System Review. Right? He gives it 4.5 stars out of 5 effectiveness, 4 stars out of 5 price, 4 stars out of 5 ease of use, and 5 out of 5 for great support. Don't know what that means. There's a lot of geezers with scarves on going, go on, Martin. Now let's look at... It's like Justin Bieber and Morrissey got into one of those pods from The Fly. And that fucking thing came out at the other end of it. Right. Now let's have a look at this article. We won't dwell on this. Oh look, pros and cons. Oh look, they're exactly the fucking same as they were in Eugene's article. TH System, everyone wants to find their true love. You know for a fact that it isn't always easy. With over 1 trillion people in the world. No. There haven't even been 1 trillion people in the history of the planet. Best estimates suggest that in people alive and dead that have ever existed, there's about 100 billion. Not a trillion. Now, should you try the TH system? Whatever. Cons. Again, pros and cons again. Again, pictures of guys who look suspiciously like Adrian but don't. On this one, on the features, they've removed bagging up, and they've just got rid of that one. I don't know. Tonality mastery. Again, this is before. This is that woman was found at the bottom of that lake. Again, the woman is looking nowhere at the block. The geezer's there. She's looking way over there. Now, here's where it gets interesting. At the bottom of this article, it says this. What people are saying about this seduction program. Still not convinced this seduction program is for you? Perhaps you need a little more convincing, and you're not alone. A lot of users who are now raving about this program started off as skeptics. One user reports that when his friend recommended the program, he didn't believe it. He thought it was a scam and won't work. Well, look at him now. The program completely changed his life. He's been able to get the ladies unlike before. That's John A's comment. So what people are saying is the fake comment posted on the fake review as now a fucking endorsement in this fake review. This one's got fuck all comments. I also found 3 YouTube videos uploaded by users who, again, were just literally people who were clearly paid just to fucking... So they just will give you a review. I have not found 1 legit fucking review that comes across as something that was written by someone who has used or taken this fucking course. Not even a shit one. Right. Now, this one's interesting. This is a completely different one. This was March 28th, 2021, on a website called Lose Weight Fast. Or Fast Weight Loss or something like that. Product name, T. Do you have dating issues? Do you want to improve your dating? To improve your way, tactics, and skills? It's the same fucking cop. He has copied and pasted the fucking fake review from 2 months ago that had a comment on it that was posted 3 years before the blog was even written, that was then used as a review in the last fake fucking review. And this is all that you find. User ratings, excellent. Editor's rating, very good. Here's a review, in a short summary of the product and blah blah. It's the same fucking bullshit product reviews and blah. This is fucking rubbish. I myself would advise this incredible product to my friends and others, specifically to those who want to start working immediately. It's simple to use. We can share and hold to ourselves too. What does that even mean? That's not even a fucking sentence. The conclusion of our product review. It sounds like a sort of review you write without mentioning the product, so you can just literally add links in. You can just add in separate words, because he's just going. It's like that scene in The Simpsons where Homer's dreaming of an invention, and they're going, why? You don't need to know what this is. You're the genius who invented this product in question. Everyone in America now owns one of these. You know, and this is what it is. It's fucking horseshit. Imagine if every review. There isn't one. Not one. This goes to his book. These are some of it, more of his book reviews, but yeah, I'm not going to waste time on them. But yeah, so there you go. That's, I should really go to his website, actually. His website, which is The Adrian G. I'm writing it in all caps for no reason. And just right from the front page, you just like... He just looks like a complete fucking cunt. Look at this fucking... What is that? What is that picture? That could be any bugger there. Look at him. Look at this fucking nonce. Look at him. What does he look like? G is a content creator, dating guru, and entrepreneur, not an entertainer. Over 100 million people have viewed his content. Yeah, not this content. We'll get onto his Twitter feed. Hold on, his Twitter feed is fucking gut. It's like the most lamest, incomprehensible bullshit. 10 ways to improve your life. He hasn't posted much in about the last month, which is curious. Let's roast some of his Twitters. His Twitter is appalling. Yeah, he says he's got 20,000 followers, but he gets fuck all engagement. Okay, this is from November the 5th. What's the point of voting when the elections are rigged? You want to talk about rigged fucking elections, mate? Your entire fucking life is rigged. Everything. Your videos are rigged. Your fucking products are rigged. The fucking reviews of your products are rigged. The comments on the reviews of your rigged fucking reviews of your rigged products are rigged. Oh no, I mean, he I don't think he did. He was very popular. I mean, like, he was legit, like, he got, like, loads of, you know, this, you know, up until that fucking, you know, what's its name? The blind man video, which, bearing in mind, that was fucking over nearly 6 years ago. No, he's not sharing hentai. It's a free game. Like, he still gets sponsors. Imagine having a product that you'd want this cunt fucking... You really think your vote is going to count? Waste of time, if you ask me. Well, I don't think I fucking did I? Raccoon turd. Right. Did you know that for every 1% increase in unemployment rate is an increase in drug overdose death rate of 3%? No. But if the unemployed, you know, people who are unemployed should not be able to afford drugs. So I imagine those ones are not connected. This is a guy who sells a fucking get-rich-quick scheme where he's literally like, you can work one day a week from your laptop from home. Presumably, for the other 6 days of the week, you're still at home. So what the fucking hell does it matter? What is the difference between someone who's unemployed and someone who follows his fucking six-figure Sunday program? Fuck staying home. This is a great tweet. Free the world now. Free the world. Make it a better place. For you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. But if you care enough for the living... Make a better place for you and for... If you wanted anything else to just be the cherry on the cake of what an absolute cockend this guy is, he retweeted Peter. Because Peter wrote a reply to him. And the reply they wrote was a reply to this comment. If everyone was vegan, coronavirus was not as spread to humans. How do you know? Yes, but not everyone's is going to be vegan, are they? Go on then. Convince fucking 7.5 billion people. Because as we know, people who are vegan never get sick. They live forever, don't they? But this is where he goes into... He just listen to this fucking lame attempts at posting these pithy, deep fucking quotes. Right. Be the flame, not the moth. Why? Like, the moth's alive. Moths don't get burnt by the flame. They just... The moth is a living thing. The fire just destroys everything. The fire has no sentience. No. What has veganism got to do with the... Well, you know, because it was passed through bats, wasn't it? So presumably vegan... I'm assuming bats aren't vegan. I don't know. I'm not an expert on this. Don't let fear get in the way of living your life. Don't let failure stop you from achieving greatness. Try more things. Do more things. That's a great... How inspiring, isn't it? It's like fucking JFK and Martin Luther King rolled up in a ball, delivered by Dwayne Johnson. It's like, do more things. Okay. Be happy, not because everything is good, but because you can see the good side of everything. I'm struggling. Well, your existence is putting a fucking kibosh on that second bit. Apart from the fact I'm getting content out of it. Your limitation is only your imagination. You, my friend. The world's most charismatic man. entertainment officer on the Belgrano. He's in Ho Chi Minh City. Do you know that Ho Chi Minh had a brother, right, who had no bottom jaw? He was called Mino Chin. Thank you. I'm here all week. Yeah. He went to Vietnam as if that country hasn't had a fucking traumatic enough fucking history. First the American military turn up and then fucking this cunt. It doesn't even sound like that. No, I wouldn't even say that. I mean, I'd give Jordan Peterson a little bit more fucking... Live with no excuses and travel with no regrets. Why? What's wrong with regretting stuff? What if you wish you hadn't gone somewhere? It's not an Instagram, it's a Twitter. What do you mean, whose Instagram is that? This is Adrian G! Are you paying attention? All progress takes place outside the comfort zone. No, it doesn't. Not all of it. For a guy who sells get-rich-quick schemes and who claims to be a fucking, you know, who claims to be a fucking love doctor, who the fuck are you to talk about comfort zones? You're hardly living on the edge of the gritty never-never, are you? See this book, if you don't sacrifice what you want becomes the sacrifice. Meaningless. Just fucking drivel. That's just that bog standard formula of where you take one thing and another thing and then you just switch them round in the second sentence and it's suddenly a deep philosophy. Yeah. The world is a book, and those who do not travel read only one page. It's a bit like reading one of your fucking books, then, isn't it? Captain fucking 78 pages. The path to success is to take massive, determined actions. Well, obviously. I'm not going to sit there, roll a dice and say, fuck it, YOLO, let's fucking, you know... You will never go broke from investing in yourself. What the fuck does that even mean? I'm not on the NASDAQ, bitch. There aren't stocks and trades, you know. You go, I'm not on the Dow Jones. One day you will wake up and there won't be any more time to do the things you've always wanted to do. Do it now. Do you know what? He's right. I'm going to find out where you live and I'm going to fucking kill you. I'm going to fucking cut you. I'm going to tie you up, peel your eyelids off and leave you in a chair facing the sun on a stick. And I'm going to broadcast it on Twitch and violently masturbate off camera. Because and if you fucking complain about it, no excuses. Make no excuses. You fucking, it's your own fault. You gave me this shit, this vague fucking motivational bullshit, all of which amounts to nothing more than a fucking, you know, a rapist manifesto. Did he write fortune cookies? That's probably, that would be something, that would be the first thing. You could probably fit most of his books in one packet of those things. Life is about moments. Again, I mean, don't wait for them, create them. What is it? What? Nothing. Everything will be so good so soon, just hang in there, don't worry about it. You just told me to make everything fucking happen! You can't now say, just chill out, sit down, relax, it'll come. The only person you should try and be better than is the person you were yesterday. Well, in your case, that ain't too fucking difficult. Christ, there are people who've got their own fucking 10-part Netflix documentaries who are fucking beating you already, mate. Yeah. Look both ways before crossing the street, otherwise the street will cross you. See? See, it's fucking easy, isn't it? It's that simple. Yeah. Piece of fucking piss. You could write fucking thousands of them. This is a great one. If something is important enough, even if the odds are against you, you should still do it. Yes, Elon Musk proving that all you need to do to achieve greatness and sometimes even the impossible is to never give up, believe in yourself, and have $176 billion. It's all you need. When I started Tesla Industries, I had two things, a dream and £176 billion. Want to see more content like this? No, I would rather cut off my penis with a rusty bread knife. Adrian G quoting Elon Musk quoting Jordan Pete. Wow, that is fucking two. That is 3 degrees of fucking vacuous, fucking empty-headed bollocks, isn't it? Now, famous birthdays. He retweeted famous birthdays. Happy birthday. Have a special day. You fucking. That's the Twitter equivalent of that episode of Mr. Bean when he fucking has dinner in a restaurant on his own and writes himself a card and he goes, oh, yeah, that's what he's doing just there. Listen to this one. It's not about how much you make, it's about how much you keep. Yes, but you can only keep what you fucking make, you prick. So it is clearly. You fucking. God, can't you plagiarise something, for fuck's sake? See, this is why he fakes everything. Because this is what happens when he tries to be impressive. Just experienced another earthquake. Oh, this is actually a tweet. I thought this was another one. This one was bigger than yesterday's. Well, that's because the earthquake is trying to be better than it was yesterday. The earthquake is just following your fucking own philosophical fucking advice. You said, the only thing you need to be better than is what you were yesterday. Well, that fucking earthquake has just shown you where that fucking kind of bullshit leads, didn't it? The real question isn't, who am I? The real question is, who am I becoming? No. Well, who are you becoming? And whoever it is, can you become it quickly? And this is a great one. This just sums up how full of shit he is. Chase money, not chicks. I'm sorry, how do you make a living again, Adrian? Doctor of love, man who spent 7 years perfecting his own pickup artist technique. Man who sells a fucking, his own system, his 5-week vocal training course to make you sound like fucking Louis Armstrong. Chase money, not chicks. That shows you how fucking good his course is. Girls, you don't need filters. You're beautiful just the way you are. They ain't. Not all of them, Adrian. There ain't no filter. You don't need filters at all. You should not even take pictures of yourself. There's no filter for you. Only God or a large... Only an act of God or a large bag could improve your fucking features. And one of those fucking options don't exist. If eating cows is okay, then eating dogs should be okay. I agree. By the way, I don't eat any meat. So you know, girls, you know. But I just don't understand people who are okay with eating cows, pigs and chickens. Well, it's conditioning, mate. But are extremely against it. Well, it's because people are naturally just hypocrites, Adrian. That is something of all the human qualities. Of all of the sort of, you know, the hypocrisies or double standards that surround the eat, the eating of meat and what we consider acceptable and not. Of all of them, those qualities, the hypocrisy is one that you should be able to relate to. Heading to Hawaii. Brilliant. I've never prayed for a tsunami in my life. Who remembers the live streaming days? Right here, right now, motherfucker. These are the live streaming days and I'm living it. I'm making my own opportunities. Guys, do you find you don't have enough time in the day? If so, check out my latest blog. If I haven't got enough time in the day, Adrian, how can I squeeze in reading your fucking shitty blog about how to manage my time effectively? I've got to learn how to manage my time effectively in order to have enough time to read the fucking blog in the first place. In fact, in the list of top 10 things that I guarantee you would be a complete waste of my fucking time under any circumstances, reading anything written by you is clearly fucking up there and expecting any fucking thing valuable to come out of it other than fucking content. Finish my Chinese classes tomorrow. I'm assuming the language. Gonna travel all around China next month. Should I vlog my adventures? No. Never vlog anything ever again. In fact, fuck off to China and stay there. If you would prefer to live in a culture where people eat literally fucking anything, you'll love China. If it ain't fucking Christ Almighty, if it can move, they've figured out a way to put it on a stick and eat the bastard thing. Have a balut while you're out there, mate. Have a balut. Yeah. Now it's just a load of fucking blog posts. We're back in 2019 now. Oh, well, that was the video I did about a month ago. 10 easy ways to make money, to make $1,000 fast. You remember what those were? Yeah. Want to earn your first $1 million? Use these principles. Yeah. Get £2,500 and move to Venezuela. Ka-ching. Yeah, I think we'll call that a day on that one. Right. But we need to have a break. she will respond to this text. Bloody messages. Dustin's, I don't know who Dustin G is. Don't care. Fuck 'em. God, I've been, this show been going 2 hours already. Bloody hell. Smoke time, you hear church bells. Yeah, that's probably because it's just gone 11 o'clock. So, they still ring the church bells because obviously there are some people out there who, you know, that's still the only way they can tell the time, you know. How does the church know what the time is? That's what I want to know. Who's up there? Do they leave some poor bugger up there? Fucking... God invented the time. Well, technically, that's true. Well, God invented the passage of time. But, I mean, we the British, invented time, you know. And that's the centre of the fucking planet. That's why the north line of longitude goes through the centre of Britain. You know, Greenwich goes through Greenwich. Greenwich Mean Time. You know? That's the north line. That's the centre of the fucking... Okay, we put the fucking line there, but fuck, it still counts. Yeah, doesn't make it any less fucking legit. Right. Now, I do have a couple. I do have... Now, I can either... Oh, God. I can either watch the... That video I responded to the last week... that Adrian made, I only responded to the first 11 minutes. It was a 41-minute video. So I didn't... There's 30 minutes of that I didn't even get to because I just couldn't be asked. It seemed unnecessary. Or I could play you a different video. So I could do the last 30 minutes of that, or I could play you a much longer but different video, which... is along the same lines as that video. It's him pitching and promoting his get rich quick scheme called Six Figure Sunday. Different video. Lewis is voting different video. I suppose that wins. Hold on. Let me pop the fucking... Now, I'm going to warn you, this video is an hour and 15 minutes long. I'm not guaranteeing I will get through all of it. I will try as best I can. Now, hold on. Okay. Just as a double check there that I didn't accidentally have any porn on the playlist. Don't want you lot enjoying yourselves. I'm going to tell you already, I've only watched like the first, pretty much the first 10, 15 minutes of this. And it's, if you remember, you know, there are going to be multiple moments in the, where you're like, didn't he say that in the last... It's going to be identical. This is basically the same video, except somehow 25 minutes, 35 minutes longer, and him selling something else. Now, I'm going to warn you now. I know you might have, some of you lot might be, you know, might have think that you have seen, you know, and witnessed some great, you know, acting performances. You know, you might have seen Brando in Apocalypse Now, De Niro in Taxi Driver, you know, Nicolas Cage in Wicker Man. You've seen great cinematic performances, and, you know, in TV and film. But the opening few, like the opening like few seconds of this, of Adrian Gigi, this is I mean this is on a level, I mean this is like discount amateur porn, you know. It's quite special.
Amazon is raising its minimum wage to $15 an hour.
Amazon is raising the minimum wage. It's $15 an hour.
Oh, big news today. Amazon raising its minimum wage to $15 an hour.
What's that? Amazon just what?
Who the fuck is he supposed to be talking to? He's got a microphone and his finger in his ear. And God knows where else that fucking thing has been. Who are you supposed to be talking? Are you supposed to be like a news reporter? What is this for? What news channel is this? Foxy Stoked News.
$15 an hour. $15 an hour.
Ready?
$15 an hour?
Do you know what, Adrian? I do a course for $25,000 that teaches people how to laugh convincingly. You should take that. You really should.
I'm sorry, I don't mean to laugh, but that's literally...
It's okay, because you weren't laughing, were you, mate? I mean, you literally weren't. That's what you were not doing, isn't it? I mean, you definitely were not laughing, so you don't have to apologise. Let me bring this in here so I can get the chat in. Here we are.
Literally the funniest thing I've ever seen in my life.
Okay, that'd be literally the funniest thing you've ever heard in your life. And, literally the funniest thing you've ever heard in your life. You know, you've never seen Monty Python, right? No, you've never seen, you know, Good Morning Vietnam. You've never seen, like, anything, Spaceballs, Freddy Got Fingered. You've never seen that. Watching the news, what's the funniest thing you've ever seen in your life? Watching CNN when they announced that Amazon was raising its minimum wage to $15 an hour. That was literally the funniest thing I've ever heard in my life.
$15 a fucking hour?
I mean, look at this. Is let's play this game that I'd like to play, which is click on any random part of the video, and in no matter where you click on, at that moment, Adrian has a face that it makes him look like a complete cunt. Look, there it is. There, yeah, there, that one. Yeah, yeah, right there. Yeah, oh, for life, bro. Yeah. There, yeah, looks like he's jacking it right there. Yeah, there. Oh, yeah. There, yeah. Oh yes, that's him. That's him. Just that's the vinegar strokes right there. Right there. That's him with his wonky lip on. Yeah, go. Yeah, that's him. That's him. That's him about to mansplain his fucking balls off right there. Yeah, that's him. There you go. See, play it at home. You can. It's impossible. There isn't one fucking single frame. There are 25 There are 25 frames a second. You fucking work this out. That you know.
I'm sorry, I don't mean to laugh, but that's literally the funniest thing I've ever seen in my life. $15 a fucking hour? Hey, Amazon, do you want a cookie?
Can I just say, did you notice how he slightly struggled to break that? Ever so slightly. First of all, Adrian, you don't have to act out every metaphor or figure of speech, right? You don't have to say, you know, when you say you want to cook, you know, first of all, Amazon is not watching this fucking video. I doubt I doubt there's anything you can teach Jeff Bezos. And this is the annoying thing about this, is that Adrian is such an unmitigated, clueless prick that for the first few minutes of this video, he is going to force me to have to defend Amazon and Jeff Bezos. But let's just watch that cookie thing again. Watch him. Watch him struggle.
Hey, Amazon. Do you want a cookie?
Do you see that? He's just like... He's like... Oh, you bastard! Fucking... Cunt! Shitting thing! Christ, it...
What an absolute joke! The news ranting and raving about...
Sorry, did you just say ranting and raving? Oh, the news are ranting and raving. Ranting? Having a rant, are you? Are you a YouTube ranter? Are you a YouTube rant and raver? We're going to a rave this evening. Oh, fucking, I've been ranting and raving all right. Cunt, he can't even say what. He can't even say basic words, fucking bro. And first of all, the news weren't ranting and raving. You showed three clips that were a couple of seconds long of them literally... just reporting, weren't they? They were just saying, oh, in news, you know, Amazon are raising their minimum wage to $15 an hour. That's a newsworthy story in a 24-hour news cycle, I think, you know. But they weren't there going, oh, a wonderful news, Amazon is going... They weren't going all drinking with Bob going, Amazon is raising the... They weren't having... Welcome to YouTube rants with drinking with What About Bob. No.
$15 an hour, like that's actually going to help your life in the big scheme of things.
Well, I mean, what do you mean in the big scheme of things? Like it's going to help your life? Well, it will help it more than, say, earning, I don't know, $10 an hour, won't it? I mean, it will help it by at least 50%. And also, Adrian, can I just point out, not everybody works at Amazon, right? This fucking... self-righteous indignation you are expressing really is only fucking applicable if I work to Amazon, which I don't.
Meanwhile,
do you know what I do for a living? This.
The CEO, Jeff Bezos, is walking around with 160 fucking billion in the bank.
Okay, I very much doubt that Bezos has got 160 billion in the bank, mate. He doesn't walk around. He doesn't have a debit card. He doesn't have his nationwide ISA account with 160 billion. That's not how that works, right? And that's a worrying statement to come from a geezer who's trying to sell me on a fucking how to make a shitload of cash scheme.
And it's not just Amazon, but that goes for any 9-to-5 job.
Any 9-to-5 job. Yeah.
Those poor workers are getting played like an Xbox.
Look, you don't play an Xbox, you play a game in an Xbox.
And so are you.
Me? How dare you?
If you're currently stuck at a 9-to-5 hellhole.
Okay, a hellhole. Okay, Adrian, here's the thing, right? Here's the difference. Jeff Bezos, whatever you think, those workers are getting paid by him. You are not going to offer to pay me fucking anything, are you? No.
Now, I don't mean to be condescending.
Oh, you could not fucking possibly mean anything else. I have never seen a man so determined. You are the anthropomorphic fucking manifestation of condescending, snotty, sneering, patronising, fucking douche-splaining fucking anything. You couldn't be more condescending. If you were more condescending, you'd have fucking... You'd have like, you know, droplets of water forming on your fucking face.
Belittle you? But the reason I'm acting so crazy is...
You're not acting... But you could not belittle me, mate. You couldn't make me feel fucking worthless.
I want you to get pissed off.
Have you not seen my video responses to you, Adrian? That's in the post, but bitch.
I want you to be mad.
It's coming.
Why so?
Well, that's a good point. I never thought about that, Adrian.
There is a known little quote from the movie The Terminator 3.
Okay, I want us all to stop here and just take that in. There is a little known quote from the movie Terminator 3. He's decided, he thought he needs a quote here from a movie or some cultural fucking signifier that people can recognise. And he chose Terminator 3. The Terminator. And it's ironic that he is about to compare himself to Arnold Schwarzenegger in Terminator 3 because in the previous video, you may remember, I used a clip from the Arnold Schwarzenegger film Predator. And I'm assuming that in the next video response I do to him, he will be Kindergarten Cop.
With Arnold Schwarzenegger, where he picks up a depressed and hopeless John Connor, who he was sent back to Earth from the future to protect...
I know the plot to Terminator 3, you fucking wanker!
Out of nowhere, he picks him up by the neck for about 5 seconds and then just tosses him to the ground.
I'm watching the clip! Can you not give me a fucking commentary? I'm not fucking blind!
Out like a bag of trash. And then John goes, what the hell did you do that for?
And Arnold, like fucking John Gielgud playing Hamlet, delivers the line.
And the Terminator replies,
get to the chopper! You are mine now. You belong to me. There is no bathroom.
Anger is more valuable than despair.
So what makes you think that I'm feeling despair? I mean, I am. I'm watching this.
Basically, the Terminator pissed him off on purpose for motivational purposes.
And so thank you for explaining what you have to do, Adrian. So Adrian thinks he is the Terminator. And he's not entirely wrong. I mean, to be fair, Arnold Schwarzenegger is fucking is Sir Anthony Hopkins compared to this fucker, and even in Hercules in New York.
And that is exactly what I wanted to do to you today.
Right. You're telling me you want to make me angry. Right. Carry on.
$15 a fucking hour?
That was Adrian G beatboxing. I could mix that.
$100, $200, $500 an hour.
But you ain't gonna pay. Yeah, are you gonna pay me that? No, I don't think you are you?
And I'm going to show you exactly how to achieve that today.
And it doesn't involve, and it involves you giving me fuck all.
So please sit back, shut down Facebook, close out Instagram, and prepare to watch this.
He said that in the last video, didn't he? Yeah. Prepare to watch this video. Motherfucker, I am 3 minutes into it. All you've done is sit there and make everyone cringe with your fake laughter, Arnold's Terminator 3 quotes, and your inability to break a biscuit in half.
Video to the very end.
To the very end. Yes. This next 75 minutes is going to go as quickly and as swiftly as the Hundred Years War.
Because what I'm about to tell you today will literally change your life forever.
Well, it would have to, wouldn't it? I mean, it's not going to... You can't say it's going to change my life and then have no... Like, it's not like causality fucking ceases to happen. You know, at some point. It's not like I'm going to revert back, am I? Did he just spit in his own mouth? Well, fucking hell, someone needs to. That's how much he hates him. That's how much of a cunt this guy is. He spits at himself. His saliva is embarrassed.
No, you won't make a $160 billion net worth like...
Why not? How do you know?
Mr. Bezos.
How do you know?
Not even close. That bastard got lucky with a $300,000 investment from his parents.
Okay, fair enough, but I don't know if that's true, let's assume it is, but not everyone who has $300,000 is inevitably going to become worth $165 billion fucking dollars, are they? Yeah, he also created what is the single largest global marketplace on Earth. You know, he did do that as well.
Do your parents have $300,000 lying around to toss you?
If they do, I'm going to be poisoning their fucking food when I visit next.
Probably not. And on top of that, the only reason he's making so much is, duh, he's being cheap and paying all his workers a minimum of 15 measly dollars.
Well, no, he's only just started doing that, Adrian. Right?
An hour. While he probably has a million...
Another great sort of acted out figure of speech.
$1 million falling out of his fucking shoe.
Who wants to bet that Adrian is doing this video with one shoe on, right? Because he had to save up his money. He had to get some money. He had to stuff it in a shoe, go and get a biscuit and put them next to the camera before doing it. And then realising he got the fucking slightly thicker ones, you know, a little bit... He got those fucking, you know, those fox cookies that are quite fucking, you know, thick. I mean, they're really, really tough. What he wanted was a rich tea, wasn't it? Or something like that, you know, or a nice... He wanted a nice biscuit, you know, or a digestive that had been dipped in tea, something like that. I've got a packet of chocolate hobnobs.
Yeah. So... Well, I can't help you make billions.
Well, then what the fuck is you so you to me?
I am going to show you how to make six figures working from the beach.
I live in the Midlands, mate. I have to get a fucking... It takes about 4 hours to get to the fucking beach from here. And it's not so much the beach, it's just where water meets dirt.
Or anywhere else in the world you want?
How about just staying here?
Right here, right now.
Okay, hold on. Didn't he not just say that Bezos got lucky with a $300,000 investment from his parents? But he just said he's going to teach me how to make six figures. So, six figures. Now, 300K is a six-figure income. Now, let's say it's the minimum six-figure income, and it's 100K, right? And that's from working one day a week, 1 hour, from the beach, or anywhere else I want, the bus, public toilet, fucking, you know, bat cave, you know, local circus, wherever. And I'm, surely if I just worked 3 days a week, I'd be earning 300K, which I would then have the same amount of money that Bezos got from his parents, and I could then use, I mean, already, we're not even 4 minutes in.
So just give me your undivided attention for the next few minutes, and you won't be the same person you were before you clicked play on this video.
Yeah, that's probably true.
I literally guarantee it.
He literally... You don't have to literally guarantee it, mate. You should just have to say guarantee. Saying literally guarantee makes me suspicious of any time you just say guarantee. You know? I am, you know, you don't have to say, you know, I am literally, I am literally a metaphor.
But before I show you how to make six figures a year by working just one day a week from...
Just one day. One day a week.
Your laptop?
From my laptop, which I don't have, by the way.
Let me tell you a little about who the hell I am.
Let me tell you who the hell I am. That was from the previous video.
And my name is Adrian Grushka.
I've heard different. I've heard Adriana Grushka. Mm? Is there anything you want to tell us about Adrian? Mm? Any secrets? You know? Mm? Are you? Mm?
But for short, you can simply call me Adrian G. And over the past
What happened to AG? What happened to the Brotherhood, man? Has it been disbanded? What happened? I thought we were clan buddies. I thought you were AG to me. You know, I called you G, Aggie. Oh, you like that, the Australians, don't you?
Nothing but one day a week while making well over six figures.
Well over six figures. Isn't over six figures seven figures? I mean, you mean well over... You'd have to name a specific six-figure amount if it's still a... Because $999,999 and $100,000 is still two six-figure incomes. If it's over six figures, that's seven figures at least...
Yes. One.
One.
Count them.
Count them. You think this guy doesn't understand economics? Right? I'm not a mathematician, right? But...
One. And with...
One.
All of the knowledge I've gained over this period of time, I've had the privilege of teaching thousands of others my tricks.
What, from what, 1 hour a week? What, 1 hour a week? You work one day a week and teach thousands of people? You must be fucking off your feet, bro.
Master the art of being their very own boss, quickly and easily.
Well, I don't necessarily agree with that. I think, you know, well over six figures is... Depends what you consider well. Well is a very vague term.
But before I became successful, making six figures a year by working just one day a week...
Just one day... One!
I worked a 9-to-5, just like you, and you, and you, and you.
I am none of these cunts, right? Look at them. Notice how all these people, they're all happy. None of them look stressed or pissed off. They're all getting on with their fucking lives, doing something productive. Right? None of them look stressed. They're not sweating. They're not weeping uncontrollably. They're not cutting themselves. Right, this geezer's got a high vis on, a fucking hat hard on. Sorry. A hat hard on. I've done it again. And he's got an iPad. This motherfucker's got an iPad. You know, he's telling her where she can go. She's like, that's the toilets over there. Go, this geezer, look at this geezer. He's so fucking chilled out. He's just, he's not even got his hand on his gear stick. He's just resting his wrist on it, going all limp there, you know. All these people look very, very, look very content.
But after going through years and years of what I politely define as hell.
Mm-hmm.
One day something just clicked. I snapped. And
yeah, I believe that. You did snap. Yeah, I believe something clicked. I think it was something in your brain.
I was able to come up with the secret path to success.
Right, were you really? Well, fuck my ass.
The keys to the kingdom, if you will, that would get me out of the rat race forever.
Mm-hmm.
So now let me tell you the quick story of how I changed my life forever and how I'm going to help you do the exact same.
Spoiler alert, he doesn't.
It all started back on June 12th, 2013.
Again, do you see how brilliant he is? Weren't you convinced that he was actually thinking? And again, he did that in the last video when he was recalling when he started, you know, when he had that date. And he said, it was June, again, 2011. So this is 2 years after that date. So presumably this is 2 years after he's... And so 2011 June, a month later, he started researching all of the fucking... best fucking, you know, what's his name's pickup artist. And then you must, and so this is 2 years later, when presumably after 2 years of study, he's now ready to go, as he put it, out in the field to take his pick of the women, who he also compared in that video. And I never played this clip. He's saying, you're going to have your choice of women like the dollar store menu, like the dollar menu at McDonald's. And I'm just like, oh, ambassador, you are, with all these Ferrero Roche, with all these Filet-O-Fish, you are spoiling us.
Yes, I remember the exact date when
I remember the exact, I can tell you did, mate, because you were thinking just then, you were definitely going, it was June... Of course you remember it. Chinny Recon, bruv. Chinny Recon.
I was hired to my second call centre job.
Your second call centre job? That comes right after first.
While I despise the first company I worked for, this one was even worse.
Right. So you're a fucking idiot then, mate.
Imagine walking into
work. Imagine what they all thought of you. I'd love to hear what everyone at your company thought of you. That's a fucking interesting video. Right? That's a documentary I want to see.
Work.
You worked for the Samaritans, I know, for one morning. Well, it was depressing. Well, I'm not surprised you spoke to five people and they all committed suicide. I wouldn't mind, but one was a wrong number. You only phoned up for the cricket scores.
Sitting in your chair and having 70 customers per day yelling and screaming at you because...
All of them. I mean, all of them. Are you telling me that everybody you phoned or everybody you spoke to... You spoke, first of all, I don't believe you spoke to 70 people a day. But even if that's true, like, they can't all have been yelling at you. Some of them must have been at least indifferent, disinterested, or maybe just forcing politeness. You know, I know this is Australia, but still.
Their phone bill is screwed up. What are all of these fees? I didn't go over my data. Are you going to pay for this, you bastard?
Oh, do you really? Yeah, you're going to pay for this, you bastard. I got your orange sherbet. Why are you taking it so personally? They don't literally mean you. They don't mean they're going to come round to your flat, a pair of, you know, with some KY jelly, some fucking jump leads, a fucking back car battery and your bollocks. They're going to fucking, they mean the company.
Yes, me.
Not you. I mean, I wouldn't mind it. If that was their policy, I would totally welcome it. Yes. Yes, sorry, Adrian. You've got to pay for this. Right?
I'm going to pay because...
No, you're not going to pay. Did you pay? No, you didn't, you fucking imbecile.
Their phone bill is screwed up. You see...
Well, then what you do, what you're supposed to do is apologise and then fucking get it sorted. Unscrew it up for them. I know that you don't really understand it. You know, you're used to just fucking things up. That's your basically your job.
Often got the direct blame from the disgruntled customer.
Yes, because you are on the fucking phone to them, you fucking absolute cunt.
Not the phone company I'm working for.
You are the phone company. You work for them.
So it's easy for my supervisor to say... The customer is always right. And
sorry, I've got new flatmates, and they just knocked on the wall, so I have to keep the screaming down. I didn't mention that. I've got new people living here now.
Expect me to wear a big, goofy smile.
They don't need you to smile, Adrian. You're on the phone. You could be sat there fucking masturbating like a fucking evil dervish. They don't care. Just maintain professional discipline.
All day. But as a human being, not...
Are you sure about that? Can we have a steward's inquiry?
A robot?
Not a robot. Didn't you 3 minutes ago compare yourself to the Terminator? Hello? Make your mind up, Adrian. The Terminator 3, no doubt. Yeah.
Just doesn't work like that.
It should do. It's quite easy.
It just doesn't.
It literally does.
And on top of that, my boss himself, Gary.
Oh, Gary. Wait till you hear about the... Oh, mate. He's going to fucking roast Gary.
Or, as I like to call him, Mr. Potato Head.
Sick burn, bruv. Fucking... Well, fucking Mr. Potato Head. Wow, God. Get some deep freeze on that burn, Gary. How'd you feel now? Who's the boss now? You fucking piece of shit, you Mr. Potato Head fucking prick. He called him this because he had no legs, you know.
Had to be the biggest arsehole walking the face of the...
So he's a potato and an arsehole. And he worked with you. I mean, he's the biggest arsehole on earth. And that's coming from you. That is bordering on a compliment. That is like Hitler calling you a racist.
I called him Mr. Potato Head.
Let me guess, did you call him Mr. Potato Head because he had a head like a potato, possibly? Yeah. I mean, I'm just going to go out of the... You know, in your world, he probably literally did.
Because he was fat, bald with hair on the side.
Well, listen, mate, you're going to fucking body shame people. Well, I bet you've got a little African child that fucking sponsors you, you skinny prick. I bet you have to draw your knees on.
Had a big, goofy moustache, glasses...
Well, I've seen more meat on a butcher's fucking pencil.
And always wore a red tie. So I bet...
He always wore a red tie. What a cunt.
Basically Mr. Potato Head in the flesh.
Mr. Potato Head, Adrian, is not made of flesh. He's made of potato. That's why he's Mr. Potato Head. That's literally what his name is.
His style of management went something like this.
God, we're going to get management style.
If he woke up on the right side of the bed, he was a decent human being and okay to deal with.
Okay.
If he woke up on the left side of the bed...
Okay. Right. First of all, Adrian, the expression is not woke up on the right side of the bed or the left side of the bed. It's the right side of the bed or the wrong side of the bed. It is not right or left, it's right or wrong. It's a very commonly used phrase. It's really fucking, you know, it doesn't matter. It's not, he doesn't even understand. And to me, does that just not sound like Gary is just like, I don't know, a human being? Like the rest of us, like sometimes he wakes up and pissed off. Possibly, did you ever consider that maybe having a work with you has got something to do with that?
He was Satan reincarnated and would do anything in his power.
He was Satan reincarnated. What do you mean Satan reincarnated? Don't you mean Satan incarnated? Satan can't be reincarnated. Satan, you know, presumably the Satan you're referring to is the, you know, Christian version of that. Then he never was, he was never dead. He can't be reincarnated. He would be the devil incarnate. You can't, you don't know anything, do you? You literally can't, you can't get anything right. You know? This is what, you know, for a guy who does nothing but fucking fill his Twitter feed with inane, meaningless drivel. Did I hear the bit about the red tie? And the potato. And the potato. And he's fat. And he's fat, you know.
Make my life a living hell. I'm guessing he has...
Good. Good for him. I hope he gets a fucking promotion on the basis. Yeah. Did you ever consider that the reason you had such a horrible time with all these people, that the one common denominator in all of this was you?
Had a volcano pit or shark-infested water on the right side of his bed.
Okay, if he did, he's not going to be getting up pissed off, is he? It's not an expression. Adrian, it's not like the side of the bed you get on has some... It's an expression just to say, this morning I happened to wake up, you know, and I was not in a good mood. It's got nothing to literally do. It's just a way of sort of... It's an expression that means I just woke up and I was immediately in a bad mood. Right? It's this thing that we have, you know, human beings have, called emotions. Try experiencing them someday.
Because seeing as he was a total ass, say... 98% of the time?
98. So he got up on the left side of the bed 98% of the time. Right.
He sure as hell loved waking up on his left.
Well, if he loved waking up on his left, then he wouldn't have been in a bad mood when he did it, would he? You can't even get the fucking narrative of this very common fucking phrase of this idiom that you have completely butchered in the first place. God almighty. These aren't even relevant to it. He's just trying to put across a simple point that his boss was a moody, you know, obnoxious prick. Fine, just say that. Don't take us on this fucking stupid journey where you go... You know, it's like that scene in Anchorman where Ron Burgundy goes, hey, when in Rome, and he doesn't know what it means.
So, between Satan, I mean, Mr. Potato Head, I mean, Gary...
Oh, God, sorry. Very, very droll. Between Satan, I mean... Are you saying that Mr. Potato Head... Are you implicating... Because, so, I mean, because Satan, I mean, he couldn't give a toss. Gary, you know, probably doesn't give a shit anyway. He was glad when you left. He was this close to bringing a fucking machine gun to fucking work, all right?
The 70 calls coming back to back.
Yeah. This is Adrian G talking about the time he was self-employed.
Of irate customers all day. Driving an hour to work in rush hour traffic, all the while making just enough to pay my bills and have $25 a month left over if I was lucky...
Yeah. Oh, luxury. Of course, you know, when I was your age, I had it tough. You know, I used to wake up 2 hours before I went to bed. Right, then I went to work in pit for 25 hours a day. I had to pay pit owner for privilege. Then I would come home. My dad would slice us in two with bread knife. And then after eating a meal of our own human shit.
Let's just say, I was probably top 10 miserable human beings on Earth.
Probably, I imagine that's... Yes, you probably were. You working in a call centre with a slightly... with a bit of a prick as a boss who's a fat geezer with a red tie who looks like a potato, but is actually Satan. And it's not just that he's Satan on purpose, yeah. He's Satan because he deliberately gets out on the left side of the bed, where he knows there are shark-infested pits and a volcano. Because he's obviously a Bond villain as well.
During this time period. You see, Gary was a type of miserable douche who...
It wouldn't be great if the Gary he's talking about is in Mendham, because that would be, oh God, what I would give to lock this fucking arse, this guy and in Mendham in a room together for a week. I give him 1 hour before Gary denounces his fucking vegetarianism and just eats him alive.
Just give me crap for the hell of it.
I don't believe that. I don't believe he was giving you crap for the hell of it. I think you've earned all the crap you get, whether it's from people who you have wronged or not. You know, it's debt that is owed.
Every single day, he would just do little stuff to deliberately annoy me and piss me off.
What did he do? What, walk around being fat?
No matter how hard I tried to be a model employee, he found great joy in just coming into work and...
I didn't rape any of the women I worked with, you know, apart from that one time, but, you know, no one found out about that, you know, because obviously she was, you know, she hadn't learned to talk yet, and, you know...
Taking his misery out on me. Adrian, lower your voice while talking to that caller.
What's wrong with that? Well, yeah, if you're talking too loudly... You put off people. I've worked at a call centre, and if you've got someone who's, if you're sat next to someone who's literally like Ian Paisley at a Sepultura concert, then yes, it's annoying. I imagine he just didn't want to hear you talking. I mean, they should play this video on, I reckon they played this audio of these videos on a loop in Guantanamo Bay.
He'd scream while monitoring my calls from his desk.
He's supposed to monitor your calls. That's his job. He's supposed to make sure it's part of the fucking job. He monitors everyone's calls. They monitor your calls to make sure that you're following the script fucking properly. Right? He ain't NAFTA. He ain't fucking spying on you.
Then the next call, he may ask me to raise my voice even though I'm talking at the exact same frickin' volume level.
Well, maybe you weren't. Maybe he misheard you. Could it be possible that he made a mistake? I mean, this is literally... I mean, they say that fucking... I mean, they say that nurses have it tough. Listen to this fucking hell. I mean, this is literally... I mean, this sounds like literally Auschwitz. Yeah.
So, yes, his hobby in life was to simply annoy the hell out of me.
I don't blame him. It's recently become my new hobby.
And eat bonbons. That's just my guess.
And he ate bonbons. Wait, you're holding it against him that he ate bonbons. Bon. Mystery meat. Quiches Lorraine. Right, you're holding it against him. You're trying to defame his character by pointing out that he ate bonbons. What is wrong with that? Oh, what a weirdo.
Yes. Based on the fact that his belly sagged damn near to his knees.
Okay, he ate a lot of bonbons, and...
But anyway, I needed a paycheck, so I put up with his BS every day.
Oh, what a fucking hero.
Because it's what I needed to do to survive.
Just you, Jesus, and Mahatma Gandhi.
So, fast forward about 6 months into my job tenure. And I'm now promoted to a team lead.
So you were... This guy was such a prick to you. This guy hated you so much. This guy took pleasure in fucking... in picking on you and making your life hell so much that after just 6 months, he gave you a promotion. What a bastard.
Not a supervisor, but a notch below. And no, I wasn't...
Yeah, you were a notch below, mate, yeah.
...promoted there by Mr. Potato Head. It came from the higher-ups who saw...
It doesn't matter who it came from. You know, do you not think he was telling you... What, you think he was telling... You know, what, so they knew that you were being picked on, and they say, rather than tell him not to do anything, they gave you a promotion. You know, what absolute fucking twaddle.
My work ethic and excellent stats, and simply couldn't deny me the raise.
Well, they could. They could if they wanted to. They could deny anybody the raise. You're not entitled to it.
If it was up to my boss, zero chance I would have ever gotten promoted.
Well, he's clearly not your boss, though, is he? Yeah.
Zero.
Zero.
So at this point, with the extra $4 an hour raise, I was at least able to pay all my bills and have a little breathing room left over at the end of the month.
Yeah, welcome to fucking reality, bitch.
Went from $25 to $300 in spare money, which for me made me feel rich in comparison to my old salary.
Well, yeah. It's spare money. So assuming that's everything paid off, all your bills, things like, you know, rent, food covered, and you've got $300. That's pretty good.
So,
considering this is, what, 8 years ago?
Mr. Potato Head was still a pain in my ass. I was finally... How can I put it?
Oh, God, please don't tell me how you're going to put it.
Content with my job.
He was content. Remember, this was a living hell, but he's content.
Well, I'm happy compared to 6 months prior. And then that's when it happened.
That's when it happened. Well, no.
A new hire that would change everything. Mm-hmm. His name was Corey Lima.
Oh, Corey Lima. Oh, yeah.
That's middle name, not last.
Who are you talking to? No one's over there, Adrian. You're not allowed within fucking 500 feet of another human being. You're electronically tagged. We all know this.
Corey?
Why did he do that? Why did he look over there? Is Corey over there? Tied up.
Was a rich preppy kid who thought he was God's gift to the frickin' world.
Oh, there's nothing... I'll tell you what, Adrian, I fucking totally agree with you, mate. There's nothing more annoying than listening to some arrogant, smug prick. Some arrogant wanker who thinks he's God's gift to it. This from the guy who calls himself Dr. Love.
He walked around in custom-made khakis, neatly pressed dress shirt with a 24-karat gold button.
Neatly pressed dress shirt? What, like the one you're wearing? Right? And I'm a man who likes pink, right? But you're fucking doing it a bad disservice there. G.
Pin to it, and a sweater draped around his neck, and a knot.
So what? Okay, he looked like a prick. Who cares?
Imagine...
No, I don't need to imagine. You've just described literally what he looked like. Yes, he looked like a white Carlton Banks. Who cares?
The president of your school's honor society...
Didn't have one.
Who had a free lifetime membership to his dad's country club and spent most of his free time on a perfectly green, exceptionally groomed golf course.
Aren't you the guy who's going to teach me how to make six figures a year by working one day a week? And you're busting on this geezer because he was born privileged, but he's still got a proper job. And I bet he was a fuck sight more easy to work with than you.
Because that's exactly who he was.
But he's not you. You know, that guy's probably making a video somewhere else talking about this fucking emaciated Australian fucking mongoloid porn inferno called Adrian G.
His parents, mother, a primary care physician, and father, the CEO of one of the largest investment banks in Australia.
Wow. Okay. And that's his fault, how?
Made him get a job at this call centre.
Okay. Good for them.
Not because he needed the money, but to teach him life lessons on working hard, since they had
Life lessons on working hard. You've just described this... You've just sat there spending 5 minutes describing working in this call centre. It basically sounds like the fucking... The prison, the Devil's Island from the film Papillon. And now you're talking about working hard.
Owed him too much up to this point. But when it comes to this guy, it seems he pretty much did anything besides work. So what's the significance of this guy besides being a spoiled, entitled little douche.
You are calling someone a spoiled, entitled. Okay. Are you sure this wasn't like a Tyler Durden thing? But instead of Tyler Durden being some sort of cool, fucking like non-conformist, anarchist, fucking, you know, sort of like terrorist geezer who looked like Brad Pitt, you just imagined some fucking like some sweater wearing frat guy, like, you know.
Back. Well, my boss, Mr. Potato Head, aka...
That's Gary.
Hey, Gary?
AKA Gary, just in case you've forgotten. That hilarious joke.
Took a strong liking to this little brown noser.
Oh, he's a brown noser now, is he? So, okay.
You see...
So what he's figured out is if he's nice to the boss, right, and he does what he wants, and he's like, you know, that it's an easier... He has an easier time.
While Corey Lima, that's middle name, not last.
Why do you keep looking off to the right? There's nobody there. And don't you dare bust on this guy because he's using his middle name as his last name. You literally call yourself Adrian G. Or AG. You don't even use your fucking name. You use the monogram of it, you pretentious cocksucker.
Didn't have too many life skills.
Does he play that piano? No. It's not even a real piano. It's probably just a fucking, like, it's probably just a bit of cardboard cutout. He didn't have any life skills. Apparently he did. Apparently he, you know, apparently he knew how to fucking, you know, he knew how to get away with doing fuck all work. That's a life skill, motherfucker.
One thing he must have learned from his CEO father was the delicate art of sucking up.
Okay. And what's wrong with that? Is he making a video moaning and pissing and moaning like a fucking, like a 1950s housewife? No. Is Corey Lima fucking infecting my fucking existence with his absolute whinging, petulant bullshit? No.
I mean, the guy practically invented it.
I don't think he did he? Because you wouldn't have known what it was. What he invented, like, kissing his bosses. I don't think he did he? You know. And isn't that your whole thing? Isn't your whole thing is like, you know, is basically doing the same thing, but instead of doing it with your boss, you do it with women who you wanna take advantage of. That's the same thing. He's just applied it to other areas of his life.
Coming in with cupcakes for the team, with especially made large ones.
Cupcakes for the team. So he went to the bakery and bought a load of cupcakes for the team, for everyone, which I'm assuming includes you.
Mr. Potato Head, giving him a bottle of cologne for his birthday.
He bought him a birthday present. What's wrong with that?
Cracking corny jokes all day, which...
Cracking corny jokes. At least, I bet they were jokes, at least. I bet I could fucking... Not you. Jesus Christ, you're like Andy Kaufman, but without any self-awareness. Yeah.
Potato Head would eat up. I mean, it was literally nauseating.
Corey Lima, that's middle name, not last. You know. Yeah. I know. Yeah. Oh, tell me about it. Yeah. No, I don't. No. What do you mean you don't exist? I don't believe you. They weren't vegan cupcakes. Good, I hope they were covered in bacon and a pig. I hope it was just a pig's ass in a giant cake.
The dead giveaway that he was the ultimate suck up was.
The dead giveaway. Dude, we get the fucking point. Could you please? I can hear my cells dying.
him always complimenting Potato Head's looks.
It's yeah, but you say that, he's vegan and yet he hates Mr. Potato Head. You know, who's the hypocrite really? Yeah.
Well, I don't normally judge...
He should be Mr. Scotch Egg. Yeah, that would make sense.
Guys, in actuality, he was easily one of the most hideous-looking creatures this world has ever seen.
And that's come at you, really? You know, okay. Yeah. Hideous-looking creatures the world has ever seen. Right. You don't have any mirrors, do you, Adrian? Yeah, no, he sounds like a cool goat. He sounds like a cool geezer. So I'd want to hang out with him. He sounds like the kind of guy who would let me fuck his sister.
But none of my business, right?
None of your business. It was fucking apparently it's our business too. Apparently this is relevant somehow. This is you trying to make yourself seem sympathetic to the people watching, and all you're doing is making us like everyone else.
Just keep on doing my job while Corey keeps kissing butt and Mr. Potato Head treats me like crap as the team lead. Right? Not a problem. Well, at least that's what I thought.
Now, apparently you didn't.
Now, fast forward a couple of weeks and Corey Lima, that's middle name, not last, has been here for a total...
Okay, it's really starting to piss me off now because he thinks this is... I don't know why he's doing this. He's looking off to the right. And I don't know what he thinks he's doing there. You know, who I don't know how I'm supposed to interpret it.
Of 1 month. And one day, while standing outside of Potato Head's office, printing out some papers, I overhear Corey in the office kissing up and telling our boss he thinks he should qualify for a team lead.
Right, so basically he's gone in there, made friends with everyone, but he's been, you know, a team player. He's like, you know, he's, you know, endeared himself to everyone. And in doing so, within a month, you know, you haven't criticised his performance. Within a month, he's saying, you know, he's saying he would like to be... He's showing, you know, he's telling him. He's not waiting to be given a fucking promotion. He's telling them, you know, that's what I want to do. I want to do that. And they give it to him. What's the fucking problem? Why is this... How is he...
So what do you think, old Gary boy?
Well... Oh, this is Adrian playing different characters now. This is him doing a skit, right? And it's gonna... You'll be forgiven if you think for a moment that Peter Sellers has been reincarnated, right? Not like the devil, right? But Peter Sellers, yeah.
We are only allowed to have one team lead at a time.
But Adrian G really doesn't count as a whole human being, let's be honest, you know.
And right now, well...
I mean, if I was king, he would be first against the wall.
What's-his-face is holding that position. But no...
What's-his-face? Yeah, that's probably a fair... I reckon he did use that term, what's-his-face, yeah.
No, trust me, I wasn't the one who promoted him, said Mr. Potato Head.
I got that, Adrian. Could you not do voices? Possibly, you know. No, he's not like Patrick Bateman from Psycho. Patrick Bateman was able to be... You know, Patrick Bateman was able to appear somewhat... Sort of, you know, he was able to smile, you know. He looked like Christian Bale for a start, which was good. Christian, you know, he also had, like, you know, muscles and didn't weigh as much as a photograph of himself. And Patrick Bateman had a proper job, you know.
Oh, wow. That's too bad. Corey responded. Well, just give it some thought and who knows what the future holds.
So he told him they can't have more than one team leader. He said, oh, that's too bad, never mind. You know, keep it in mind if it's ever available, you know, for the future. What story do you think you're telling us?
Sure thing, buddy. I'll see you on lunch. Potato.
I'll see you on lunch. at Yelp. You're not making me like, you're not making me dislike either of these guys.
So before Corey could open the door to leave, I scurried around the corner.
You fucking poof. You big girl's blouse. You fucking woolly woofter. Fucking... I ran around and I hid in a bin. I hid behind... I put a lampshade on my head and stood there like that. No one knew anything.
To the break room, heart beating fast in somewhat disbelief.
What? At what? A guy asking for a promotion or putting his name down to be considered for one and then being told that it's not possible and then responding by, oh, okay, never mind then. This guy's unbelievable.
But at the end of the day, I'd been in this position 4 months, at this job 10 months.
Right.
And my...
And so what? Did he know? You know, was Corey Lima, that's last middle name, not last, was he aware that they couldn't have more than one team leader? Did he know that? Because he seemed to accept it quite when he was told. Yeah. He didn't seem to, he didn't stab you in the back. Why should he care what you think? You're the, you know, if he could hear what you say now, he probably would have fucking tried harder. He probably would have rolled you up in a carpet and had you buried in his... in his daddy's golf course at the country club. And you, and if you're talking about country, you know, as Stephen Fry once said of Piers Morgan, to paraphrase him, you know, to murder Adrian G is the definition of countryside.
That spoke for themselves, so I knew I had nothing to worry about. Now, fast forward...
I knew I had nothing to worry about. Could you get to the point then, please, Adrian? Because... so far, this entire story amounts to nothing happened.
About 2 more weeks. And Mr. Potato...
I mean, it's gripping stuff, this. I mean, it's fucking... it is. I'm on the... I'm on the edge of something.
Potato Head is now giving me way more shit than usual. Way more. When I say a bug was practically up his ass 24-7...
Well, have you got a bug and an ass just to show me... show me what this looks like. You're like one of those silicon arses. You've got one of those. And a bug to stick up it, so I know exactly what you mean.
I really mean it. He was yelling a little louder at me, being a lot more impatient, and seemingly trying to find the smallest of things to give me a hard time about.
I'm getting the impression, Adrian, that he doesn't like you. And to be quite honest, I can't see why that's unreasonable.
One day, he came up with some lame problem that... I left the file cabinet open and it was a safety hazard for employees and that I could get in big trouble for it.
Well, it probably could be. It depends where the filing cabinet was. You know, someone could, if it was near a doorway, someone could trip over it. If it was a bottom one, someone could trip over it. You know? If it's a place, if it's an area where people are walking around a lot and they might not necessarily watch where they're going.
He just went out of his way to screw with me at this point. Fast forward... another week.
God almighty. Fucking hell. This is like the opposite. Whatever the opposite of Alfred Hitchcock is, this motherfucker is doing it.
And it's fine.
What's the opposite of suspense?
Only the weekend and I can relax. Saturday, I just took it in.
It's the weekend. Ooh, I'm blinded by the light.
Easy and play some video games. And Sunday, after laying on my couch for a few hours... I got up and got dressed and went to church.
You were laying on the couch naked and then went to church. You went to church after being on the couch for a few hours. What time do you get up? And what do you go to church for? Oh, I get it. They must have had a woman vicar. You just sat in the back row, didn't you? Masturbating.
And that's when I received the text message that would alter my life forever.
Mm. Right, so you could have just started here. You could have... the last 10 minutes of this video could have easily been fucking skipped over. And you could have just... but it would alter his life forever. It was from your dad. So I'm thinking of you, son. I'm in the bath and I'm hard.
Hey Adrian, sorry to inform you, but due to your conduct lately, we have decided to go in another direction.
Yeah! yes, he got the sack. Get in there. Go on, potato. Potato. In the words of Joseph 8276, potato.
I wish you luck in future endeavours.
I hope you get hit by a truck the second you step out into the road, you fucking waste of... You fucking support system for spare organs.
Sitting there, in the middle of church with the opera passionately singing their hearts out.
The opera. The opera at a church on... What the fuck is the opera doing? Like you went to see opera.
I'm already not supposed to be on my phone, but I do check it in emergencies. So
how do you know it's an emergency? If you've got your phone on you, you wouldn't know it's an emergency unless... But you know, that's very considerate of you for keeping your phone on so it's beeping during a fucking live performance of an opera that people are trying to enjoy, which presumably is quite expensive.
I message my boss right back.
Oh right, here we go. Yeah, this is where shit. You know, this is where shit gets real, dog.
Gary,
you text with two fingers like that, dear. Okay.
What exactly?
Okay, how big is your phone? He's doing this. Dear Gary. And I gave it, tied it to the leg of a pigeon and fucking...
Are you saying? And he responded...
And he sent a gif of Vince McMahon going, yeah, fine. Adrian G. Yeah, fine.
Words I'll never forget.
I'm gay. Eat potatoes, bitch.
You're fired.
No, he said, yeah, fired.
And at that very moment, my heart sunk so deep into my chest, I could feel it touching my stomach. It hit me so fast and so...
It's the only thing that's touched your stomach in a while.
Heart, I was so distraught, I literally forgot where I was.
You're at the opera. Yeah.
With my head currently...
I mean, God, it's like he's never lost a job before in his life. You're a grown-ass man, as I believe, as they say in America, you know.
Spinning, racing 1,000 miles per hour. I lifted up my fist and hit...
You wouldn't know that this was the worst job on planet Earth. Like, it was literally... It was like a Korean prison camp, but with phones.
The bench as hard as I possibly could. And among the 200 or so churchgoers in attendance, it was a collective gasp and embarrassment within me that I can...
The vicar was overheard saying, get that cunt Adrian G out of here, for fuck's sake. He works for Satan, I've heard. Mm. A potato-headed, a fat Satan with a red tie. Get out of here. Get out of here, G, you paedophile, rape-faced fuck.
Never forget. After the chorus came to a screeching halt.
So he brought... I'm sorry, this is bollocks. You did not bring an entire opera to the halt because you got fired. Right.
I hopped up, fully red-faced, and ran towards the exit.
It was like the opposite. It was like the reverse version of The Graduate when he runs in at the end. He's running out of the church, going, Mr. Potato Head, Mr. Potato. It's like Douglas Wrenham in the IT Crowd going, Potato.
Young man.
No, they did not call you back. I was like, let that motherfucker run. Yeah.
The pastor yelled.
The pastor yelled. Yeah, fucking, yeah. He went, oi, wanker!
There's nothing to be embarrassed of.
I think there fucking is. He should be.
We all come to church as...
You're Adrian G. There's plenty to be embarrassed about.
We are. Step here to the pulpit and let your frustrations
Does
be...
Does anyone... But this entire story could be filed under the subreddit That Happened.
Hurt. I turned around slightly and made teary, pupilled eye contact.
I don't care.
But then just kept running towards the exit.
I don't care.
I then hop in my car and call my boss's phone several times, but he never does answer. Now, immediately racing through my head was all my bills, rent, food. Where the hell was I going to stay? How the hell was I going to live? I thought.
Suck a dick, bitch.
I mean, I really just got replaced by a spoiled rich kid who'd only worked there for 1 month. This was the most insane thing I'd ever gone through in my...
This was the most insane thing. Have you ever, like, lived a life? This was the most insane thing?
Entire life. But...
Everything with this motherfucker is the most of something ever, isn't it? Nothing's just bad or good or all right. It's always the most ever.
I was determined to fight and not drown in my own misery. So
that's a shame. Yeah.
My next course of action was to say, fuck Mr. Potato Head.
Your next course of action was to fuck Mr. Potato Head. You know, as opposed to the melon that you normally microwave.
I'm going to find me a new job.
Wow, that sounds like a perfectly sensible fucking reaction that literally every other human being would fucking have. Without disturbing an entire fucking operatic performance. You inconsiderate fucking asshole.
So, I go home, hop on my laptop, and start searching for jobs non-stop at this point.
Non-stop? I think you did stop at some point, didn't you?
And... this is the typical response I got.
Oh, fuck off, you. Fuck off, Adrian. Mr. G. I've heard about you. Mr. Potato Head. Mr. Potato Head's got a lot of fingers in a lot of pies. Yeah.
Sorry, we don't have any spots available.
Right, so that, yeah, okay. Well, then, how. Well, if they don't have any spots available, what were you applying for? You can't have been looking for jobs, because. Why would you apply at a job for a place that wasn't advertising one?
Not hiring right now. Try back in November.
Okay, so they didn't have any jobs, but you're not looking for jobs then?
We'll let you know once something opens up.
Yeah, like your mum.
This is what I got from the first 50 or so jobs I'd sent my resume to.
It's because they didn't. What do you want them to do? Fucking beam a job out of nowhere for you? Yes, we'll make you head Adrian. God, it's hardly Cut My Life In. When does Cut My Life Into Pieces by Papa Roach start playing?
2 weeks later, as I'm laid back, panicking,
Not looking for a job, you'll notice. Non-stop looking for a job. Yeah, he gave up. There's literally no jobs anywhere.
Sitting on my couch, still without a job, I decided to finally go check my mailbox, which I hadn't done in over a week as I was just too...
Wait, so you've sent your CV off, your resume off, to 50 or 60 places, but you haven't checked your mail in over a week.
Busy and depressed job hunting to even think about it. Then, as I was putting on my slippers to go check...
You put on your slippers, you absolute... Of course you've got slippers. I bet you wear one of those silk kimonos that comes up just beneath your balls, don't you? You fucking... with a glass of brandy. Cunt.
I was suddenly energised by a burst of hope and optimism.
Did you stand up too quickly and get a head rush?
Hey... maybe one of the jobs I applied to sent me an acceptance.
But fucking well done!
...and server in the mail. Let me hurry up and go check, I told myself. Now, outside, frantically sifting through the pile of mail, throwing away a dozen or so
ads. You do know you are thick as shit. You don't know. That's what you're putting across. You are literally fucking mentally subnormal.
Advertisements. I see one white envelope and my eyes get big as I rip it open. Inside I'm...
It says, this is your once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to send us a check for £55. Wow. Dear sir or madam, beg your pardon.
Hoping, praying that this is the job I've been waiting on.
Gay porn fluffer. You know it.
And now, as I open the letter and
take... Oh, God almighty, would you fucking get the pissing bastard shitting fucking wanking on with it.
Take out the folded sheet of paper. Rather than a job acceptance letter, I'm now...
It was a piece of human shit from Mr. Potato Head saying, eat this, you faggot.
Staring at my worst nightmare.
Your worst nightmare? What would that be? A woman with full confidence, self-esteem and autonomy. Right. Who's sober most of the time. Was that what it was?
Eviction scheduled for Monday, July 21st, 2014.
Monday, July 20... Hold on. He was talking earlier. Hold on. Oh, wait, so this is now a year later. That's a year of your life you've just described? Because it was June 2013, wasn't it, when this story started? It's taken you 15 fucking minutes to get to this point. God, Jack and Ori would have gone on for a fortnight with this prick, wouldn't they? You are not Peter Ustinov, mate.
I step back slowly, taking several deep breaths, almost hyperventilating.
God, have you ever had had like a sort of just normal reaction to anything? Do you have to be a fucking melodramatic fucking drama queen? Christ almighty. Your name should be Adrian OMFG.
Holding onto the mailbox so not to pass out and hit my head on the concrete floor.
Oh, that would have been fucking hysterical.
I take a few minutes to gather myself and then start to slowly walk towards my apartment.
Can you imagine looking at this?
And that's when it suddenly dawned on me.
I'm
really just slaved for this crap job for 6 months.
I'm a massive cunt.
Took shit from a boss with a permanent thumbtack in his ass, stressed out of my mind.
Nobody
likes
me. I have no friends.
And all I have to show for it at the end of the day is the possibility of sleeping under a bridge in the next 10 days.
Like a troll, you mean?
This is the moment I knew I could never put my livelihood into another human being's hands ever again.
But you do, Adrian, because even doing what you do now, being, yes, you're your own boss, but your livelihood now depends on more than one person. It depends on hundreds or thousands of people giving you their money. So that's even more of a responsibility. Right? We all put our livelihood... We don't make money out of nothing, do you? Well, I mean, you have.
And I made that my personal vow. As I hold onto the letter, still staring at it in my hand...
It's just a big middle finger. Picture of his landlord going.
In 0.5 seconds, my emotions suddenly turned from...
Who remembers that? 0.5 seconds.
Sad and distraught, feeling sorry for myself.
Do you think you might be mental, Adrian? You sound like you've got very, very strong mood swings.
To outright enraged and livid.
And he's still just in his slippers, nude, completely nude, in the street, in his slippers, almost passing out, then becoming livid. Like, an erection, barely visible in broad daylight.
as the true totality of the damage that Mr. Potato Head and Corey Lima wrecked on my life had fought.
Yes, it was all about you. It was personal, wasn't it? It was all about you, wasn't it? That's all they wanted to do was wreck your life. Your life already is... You being Adrian G is your fucking punishment. It is your crime and your punishment, all rolled into one.
Finally started to set in. That's when I go home, hop on my laptop in a feverish attempt to save my life as I know it.
Namblar.com. Motherless.com. Oh, look, he Googled how to make money
online.
Right. It took you this long to fucking Google that, did it? I mean, still naked in his slippers. Right.
Is the first...
How to kill a fat potato-headed bastard. Google Corey Lima gay porn. Nothing, bugger.
Thing I Googled, but came across nothing but a bunch of spammy rip-off sites just trying to get me to click all their ads.
Who'd have thought it, if you Google how to make money online, all you come across is spammy rip-off sites? And they thought, aha, I could be one of the geezers who owns one of those sites.
So that's when I sat back and try to really think.
I mean, how does one think? I mean... What does one do? I mean, do I think about thinking? I mean, think. You better think about what you're trying to do to me. Yeah, think.
How can I, as a single entity...
Why? Why say that? What do you, on the off chance that people watching this are duelists... How can I, as a sick... That is... If that is not insecurity about his own fucking schizophrenia, he's just making sure you know. How can I, as a sane human being who's totally not fucking mental, right, who is in control, rational, right, who doesn't need medication...
Not a company, not with a group of lazy friends, how can I... create a large, constant amount of revenue.
Well, of course not with a company. You're unemployed. Of course not with a group of lazy friends. You don't have any. Right? Look at that face.
But I could simply take care of myself and not be at the mercy of another miserable human being like Mr.
Your entire fucking career that you have laid out for yourself is based on miserable human beings. They are your fucking currency, bitch. Miserable, sad, worthless sacks of shit. Whose lives have become so fucking filled with and bereft and filled with despair and misery that they look at you as the last gleaming hope. You are the warrior standing at the gates of oblivion. That's how bad their lives have gone. Right, you think your life is bad? Imagine being someone whose fucking life's gone so bad, they look to you as the fucking... they aspire to be you.
How? So I started thinking about some of the highest paying professions in the world.
You know, you could have been, what, Jeff Bezos? No, not Jeff Bezos. No, you can't... Who wants to be that cunt? Yeah. Highest paid professions in the world. Fish, you know, trawlerman. That's quite high paid. It's very dangerous, though. You could die. You know, you would die. Work on an oil rig. Astronaut. Professional footballer. Or any sports athlete. Hollywood actor. I mean, you try it. You're an actor. And we've seen, I mean, how you are not getting... I mean, you will be the next James Bond, you know. It won't be in a James Bond film, but that's what it will be. It'll be the film you wrote yourself.
doctors, lawyers, hell, even scientists.
What, you just thought you could become a doctor, a lawyer, or a scientist? Do you know what I want to be? I want to be Chancellor of the Exchequer. I'm going to send my resume in. Yeah, wherever you works, I've worked at a call centre, motherfucker. Mm. The bells.
I tried to think why they make so much money. Like,
because they know something that's complicated that not a lot of other people do, and it's useful. Why do they make so much? Who asks themselves that? Who's it? Why do lawyers and doctors, you know, people who can get someone out of a lot of trouble and spare them prison time, you know. Someone who could save someone's life or cure them from a disease. You know, people who literally discover things that make the world a better place for human beings. That's... what do they do? What's science ever done?
They do. And that's when it hit me.
What? Someone's fist? Right, in the bollocks, please?
All of those professions I just named actually have a valuable skill.
Do they really? Well, fuck my pubic hair.
They aren't simply playing Mr. Secretary like I was doing to my own...
We know this, eh? Everything you're telling us, we already know. Nobody doesn't know this. How did you not know this beforehand? Were you sat back thinking, fucking lawyers and doctors, slackers, what do they know?
Old boss. They actually bring something to the table that any random Joe Schmuck...
I think you'll find that lawyers and doctors do have bosses, Adrian. They're not renegades, right? They're not fucking mavericks who are just operating outside the law.
The street can't just wake up one morning and do. But here is the obvious. My rent is due in 2 weeks.
And this has got what to do with... And I care about this. Why?
I don't have time to go to school for 80...
Right, I'm telling you this now. I am giving this motherfucker till 30 minutes in. And if he hasn't started talking, I'm just gonna fuck it. I cannot take any more of this shit. Right. This has now been going on... Hold on. This has now been going on for fucking... Holy shit. This has been 90 minutes, nearly. It's taken me 90 fucking minutes to get 22 minutes into this fucking, this audio-visual fucking, cure for fucking insomnia. This piece of shit. This is the Uwe Boll of fucking internet vlogs, mate. This is... I mean, I cannot... I'm scared if I watch all of this in one go, I'll have flu and ME by the end of it. It's fucking intolerable. That's a good point, actually, Fimoff. I didn't notice that. Why is his rent due in 2 weeks, but he's got 1 week's notice for... Maybe it's because... And I'm going to go out on a limb here. Maybe it's because this story is complete bollocks. It's all... lies. None of it actually happened. He actually wrote this. Like, he made this up. What makes it more believable and slightly, makes you think it's a real story is because you would not choose to write something this fucking boring. Would you? I mean, you wouldn't deliberately set out to write a fake story that made you look sympathetic, but also, the underdog and inspirational, and come up with this. I've watched the most pretentious fucking Eastern European fucking art project films that have got more fucking action in them than this.
Is to become a lawyer.
Marcel Marceau's vinyl album had more shit going on.
I don't have time to go to school for 13 years to become a doctor. In 2 weeks, 14 days.
Well done. You see, I told you he's good at maths. Like, 1, 0, and he's just worked out that in 2 weeks, he does not have enough time to go to college to become a doctor. He's sharp, you know.
It's 336 hours, 20,160 minutes, or however the hell you want to count.
Adrian, I know how long 2 weeks is. It's going to be how long I fucking am going to be sat here by the time I fucking, if I choose to sat through this video, right? Do you know what else is taking a long time, mate? My fucking life.
Calculator? If I don't have my freaking rent paid, I'm going to be sleeping under a bridge or behind a gas station with spiders and snakes as my new next door neighbours.
I feel sorry for them, yeah. Don't worry, I think they'll leave you alone. Who the fuck's going to want to bite you? You could probably get eaten, but you could probably get eaten and swallowed by your average fucking anaconda and you wouldn't even notice. You wouldn't see a single bulge. It'd be like, you know.
I had to figure out something now. Now. Now.
It scream now more. You know, that might help.
So then I tried to think of something I was already good at.
Right. Okay, I'm out of it, no.
That I wouldn't have to go to...
You know what you're good at? You're good at writing fake reviews for your own products. That's fucking something you evidently have a passion for.
School for a decade just to learn. I was a pretty good surfer, but how...
Right, well, why don't you fucking... Why don't you Patrick Swayze at the end of Point Break then? You know? Why don't you fucking do that? Be a hero. End it all now. I was a pretty good surfer. Get eaten by a shark. That would be hilarious. Cut fucking thing would probably spit you right back out. He'd probably use you as a toothpick.
I'm going to make money doing that. I wasn't half bad at car detailing, but I could never make enough money doing that consistently.
What, because people don't have dirty enough cars or you just can't be asked?
To cover my rent. There had to be something I was good at.
Talking bollocks? Is there a fucking... Is there a job you could do where you just literally drivel on for fucking an interminable, fucking life-threateningly dull amount of time?
Something where I could give value to the world that I was actually passionate about. And that's when I received a text message from one of my lady friends, Amber.
Oh God. One of my lady friends, Amber. Yeah. Vagina hurts. Lusty McTits and jugs.
That said, hey babe, what you up to? And that's when I had my money-making epiphany.
I could fucking, I could make porn with her.
You see, Amber was a girl I met at the grocery store. Got her number and have been having some fun with her ever since.
Okay, what's this fun? What is this? What the fucking hell is this shit? What's this punctuating in the fucking air? Fucking every time I see, whenever I see someone doing this incorrectly, I just feel the only way to punish them is by doing every other form of punctuation. Like, it's by responding, going, yeah, I said, darling, yeah. You said what?
And she was just one of many, many girls.
Many, maybe two. If you round up from one.
A roster. All my guy friends.
On my roster. Who says that? Who describes the women they know as a roster?
Would always ask me, how the hell do you pull so many girls so easily?
I don't think they ask it like that, do they, Adrian? I believe they ask that question, but they ask it in a more incredulous way. Like, how the hell do you pull so many women? I mean, How many blind, deaf masochists could there possibly be in your local area?
I would simply smile, shrug my shoulders and say, I have no idea, I just sort of do my thing. But this is when I really...
They've all got gonorrhea.
...realize that I do have a skill. And not just a skill, but a skill that we...
You just literally said you don't know how you do it. If you just do... If something just happens, but you don't know how you do it, then it's not a skill. It's just dumb fucking luck.
Valuable to other people, which is the key. So, while I could never go to school to...
So you could teach other fucking emaciated, weedy pieces of shit like you how to get women that are way above their station.
Be a dentist or a surgeon, per se.
Per se. Who's per se? Who's per se? I couldn't be a surgeon or a dentist, per se. Per who? Who's Percy?
I guess you could just call me the love doctor.
Oh, for fucks. Excuse me. I need a fucking... No. He didn't. Tell me you did not just say that. The love doctor. Dr. G. Adrian G. The love doctor. I know he does, mate. I know. It doesn't matter. Both his stories are bullshit. I know, like, the last video, he'd already done this 2 years prior, when he went out with that fucking, you know, that woman who looked like some other woman I've never heard of on steroids, whatever the fucking hell she was. That woman who did what every woman and human being should ever do who meets this cunt, just laugh at him and walk away. You know? But that's the contempt this guy has for his audience and for any people. He's like, he's got two videos that are still on his website that are literally telling two different versions of reality that are, you know, that cannot both be true at the same time, but he doesn't care. Yeah. You know, I get that reaction with a lot of the women I've gone out with. People are like, how did you end up with a woman who looks like that? And I'm like, well, you know, I've got no money, no fame, status or power. You know? Yeah. Just personality and a huge knob, I suppose. I don't fucking know. Who gives a shit? It's their problem. I don't ask questions.
Because I was as good at picking up chicks as any man walking.
And he even filmed it. You know, this totally is real. Yeah, look at him outside the yacht club. Right. Look at her fucking... She's got a fucking big old pair of tits on her. Anyway, sorry. I mean, oh, she... whatever.
On Earth. But the thing is...
Just a camera. Just 2 feet behind him, you know? Not totally real. I don't think this guy has ever filmed him... I don't think this guy has ever appeared on camera and had everything... and ever done anything genuine ever. Everything about, he's got that Orini-esque quality where everything is manufactured.
While I had all the knowledge and secrets in the world on how to help guys pick up women.
All the knowledge and secrets. You just said you didn't know how you did it. So you had no knowledge. You know, you're like a geezer who just wins the lottery every fucking 4 weeks. Like, how do you do it?
There was still no way I could create my own product and package it within 2 weeks before I was out on my ass from this eviction notice.
Mm-hmm. So, home.
There was just simply no way. So what I did was head over to an internet marketing message board and ask them for advice on how to make money using my dating advice talents and make money fast. And that's when a senior member suggested that I sell someone else's product, who has already took the time to make it, another dating guru per se. So what I did was search for other decent dating products, created a blog where I could give away my own personal tips and secrets on picking up women, and then add the other guru's products to my blog. If I sell the product for the other guru, I would get 75% commission for making the sale, and they would get the other 25% since they own the product. It's a win for me and a win for him. He gets 100% free sales that don't cost any advertising dollars, and I get to make money using my passion without having to create my own product. So I rush to get the blog set up within about 2 to 3 days and then add the product. Now that I had a pretty decent looking blog, I start looking to find a way to get people to visit the website. So what I did was simply promote the blog using my current Facebook page and asking a couple of my buddies to do the same on their page. After the first day, I could see myself getting visitors, people reading the post, even liking them. But no sales are coming in. 87 likes and not one sale. What gives?
I'm done. I can't. That's how I'm ending. No. In one go, it's not fucking possible, right? I know that I have violated, I know Adrian said at the start, he said, Richard, he didn't say my name, but he was talking to me. I mean, because I feel like we're brothers at this point, obviously, distanced, ginger-haired stepchild sort of thing, but he said make it to the end of this. I can't make it to the end. I am a guy who completed an entire marathon in one go, right, with fucking with paralyzed feet and fucking leg braces, right, with 7 months training, and I completed a marathon and didn't even come last. I cannot watch more than half an hour of that fucking just abomination, right? Whoever or whatever the fuck he, I cannot fucking manage it. I have had big fucking hooks this big pierced through the skin on my back, on my shoulders, on my legs, and above my ankles, and I have had those hooks attached to the ceiling and pulled, and I've been swinging through the air, hanging from my skin on purpose, right? And I lasted longer doing that than I could watching this fucking cunt, right? That's the level, right? That's how bad and terrible that man is. And I make no apologies. You can find it, that video is on the internet somewhere. Right? Search it out at your own fucking peril. Delete your search history. I mean, Aurini was a boring, fucking, drippy, humourless, fucking, phony human being. But at least his videos only went on for, 8 minutes. Roosh V is a fucking contemptible, vile piece of shit. But his videos don't go on so long that I fucking lose the will to live. I have to watch at least 4 of them. Well, I think that's how he... I think I'm convinced that's the only way he has any success with women, is he just fucking... He talks to them long enough that they lose the fucking will to live, and they're willing to blow him just to make him fucking leave him alone. Oh, God. Anyway, folks, I think we've learnt... I think 3 and a bit hours of Adrian G is more than enough for all of us tonight. And so, I hope you've enjoyed this. I'm going to knock it on the head. Thank you all for coming. And there is a moral to all of this. There is ultimately something we can take, a lesson we can take away from this. If you figure out what that is, email it to me.